On YouTube. Hi everybody. How are you doing? Today is late OP. Yesterday was the first time where I was not late OP, but today is late OP once again. So welcome to the normal world. Thanks a lot for everybody tuning in. Thanks to everybody. Just want to get a few things out there, some self-promotion, because what else is there to do in life? This Saturday and Sunday, I'm doing two shows, Rant of the Pant and Traveling Pants. One is about traveling all over the world, and one is about why we can't travel all over the world. So it's good fun. It's fun. I'm saying for my own show. It's great. It's the best show you'll see this year. It's one of the worst shows you'll see this year, whatever it is. SaurabhPant.com is tickets. Again, Saturday, Sunday, two separate shows. You can see both with different content, except the ball jokes. So come for that. It'll be fun. Also want to thank a few people who donated on InstaMojo, Sai Kiran B and Ramneek. Thanks a lot. And people on PayPal, Roshan Rutre, who's given before. Thanks, Roshan. You're a great man. Anish Joshi, thanks. Nikhil Uchil, Shri Harsha, Mamila, and Arya Paturkar. Thanks a lot to all of you guys for keeping this stuff running and motivation in form of cash. Good morning to everybody. Good morning to K. Devarama. Good morning to 57 Kunal Kadu. Good morning to Rushikesh Kulkarni and everybody. If you've never seen the show before, the way it works is I bring on guests. We chit chat and talk. Absolute nonsense, and then hopefully we try and take some questions from Super Chat. And if I don't take a question on Super Chat, please relax. I will try my best. If it can't happen, it won't happen. Thanks. I hope you understand. Also, we started a separate channel with snippets from this podcast, and the link for that will be in the description. Videos go up there every day, 4 o'clock. So go check that out for people who are like, "Itna lamba kaun sunega?" Okay, very excited about this one, guys. Miracles are happening. Miracles are happening today. Kaan Masti is here. And this is the most glorious day. So I'm just going to introduce all of them at one go. Please give a round of applause to Suresh Menon, Cyril D'Abrio, and Jose Covaco. Hi, friends.
Hi, how's it going?
Who's
It's what
that
is. I shaved today,
young? Oh,
so
good. I thought it's a Suresh son on the show.
Don't talk about
I thought you were doing an
that.
impression of me.
I don't think that really fulfills it. Has someone told Jose how to put a webcam on,
Oh,
or should
yeah.
we? Yeah,
Maybe. You
yeah.
think I should help him?
Yeah. This is, I'm sorry, guys. This is how normally most of our podcasts start. Jose tries to figure out where the USB ports are. And he tries to be late because he's the kind of popular guy. So, so he
You know,
does this.
I just want to say that because of Saurabh's great technical advancements, it literally says over there, the host has stopped your video.
Okay, now tell us
The
the
host
truth.
has asked you to start your video. See, इतना सुमड़ी में
Oh,
सुमड़ी में
cool,
होकर मैं
cool.
सो रहा था इधर और तुम लोग क्या कर रहे हो? My God, it's actually happening.
Oh
I've
man,
decided to sleep
unbelievable.
here at the computer only just to make sure this happens. Oh
Yeah,
my God, Cyril, Suresh, what is happening here? Are we recording our podcast?
I'm audience
exactly.
member. Hey, by the way, Cyril, the mic is supposed to be in front of your face. Jokes.
Oh
Hey,
shit! That's it.
hey, you know what? One of the most joyous moments of this podcast has been Jose doing his tech and looking like he's never slept in his life.
God,
The only person I've
crazy.
seen more confused was Tanmay. So this is great.
नाइस हाँ साला तुम लोग मेरा बंद करते फिर बोलते हैं कि मेरा टेक डोंट फूल मी सौरभ
Yeah, I don't think we've ever seen Jose up this morning. Like, I haven't seen him with morning light. We don't know
This
what he's
early
up
in the
to.
morning.
Yeah.
Bro, I
Excepting
set my alarm for 10:59.
Wow.
Still, I was early.
And that you set at 10:45.
Yeah.
Because you're pretty
How many
much
people
awake
have
playing
tuned out
games.
now so far? Sorry.
We're
How
down
many
to
people are like, well, going? Mob, nahi
minus
kar
23
sakta.
viewers. The only people watching are people who are watching sarcasm.
I've never seen they're watching ironically. Very nice.
Yeah, I think
Hey,
Saurabh
Saurabh
needs
is
your internet
frozen.
package, Suresh.
Yeah, I know.
Right, now that
Listen.
we got rid of Saurabh, let's
Oh.
just start Kanmasti. Go
We
ahead.
have someone with worse internet than Suresh.
So, what's up? So, Suresh, you're looking good.
It actually hung. I think Saurabh's computer has hung.
Saurabh hangs well, I must say.
Yeah. Well, I told Saurabh not to use the microwave oven this time, but he just, you know, anything.
He's back.
He's a nice guy.
Sorry, there's weird things happening in my house with the lights going off every 2 hours. And they go off for pretty much 23 seconds and then come back because Adani is great. So it's very exciting.
Oh, you
could
have
be
like
someone in your house and the main switcher.
Adani's great, guys. Hey, by the way, do you have this problem in your house of like did you guys have the heavy electricity bills and all? How much did yours come to?
Oh, bro, mine came to like what, 15 or something. But then I think it was a couple some months together. God knows what happened. I still have no idea what happened. I'm still in shock.
See, without
mine was a little higher. Mine was around 20k, but that's because I've been putting my finger in the socket every time, so it maybe that caused issues. I don't know.
That explains the hairstyle also. So no, I calculated. I got a humongous bill. Then I went back to my last year's bills, and then I saw the difference what they charged for the 3 months that they just put a average charge that they put and what it should have been. They were right, by the way. So then I started beating up my children.
Yeah.
Then so is this the point, Saurabh?
Doesn't even have an electricity connection in his house.
Yeah. Is this the point where we ask Super Chat now to help us pay these bills? I mean, how does that work?
Okay. Yeah. So can you guys please raise money for Jose to pay 15,000 bucks, Cyril to pay 23,000 bucks, also for Cyril to stop being able to conduct electricity? Because
That's true.
63,000
bucks.
What? What?
No, Suresh, that was for the surgery you paid, Baba.
Suresh, you got charged 63,000.
I'm just going with the flow. If I get like some extra money, then I can perhaps pay my kids' fees and all that stuff.
Maybe you left your phone charger on like all night or something.
That's
insane. Wow.
So it was more than
ghar pe kaisa bhai log.
I feel like this is a WhatsApp video call now. Like, you know, Saurabh is calling me, check on us. And like, hey, what's up, guys? How's it going? I was like, yeah, it's fine. Sab theek hai.
How's your electricity bill going?
Power bill kaise hai? Sab theek hai na? Hey, guys. Woke up in the morning.
If you guys need to talk to anyone during this lockdown, you know, please feel free, guys, to talk to one of your friends. Okay? Don't fucking call me. Okay?
Because... I don't know.
You know, I think for some people, this might be a little weird because the thing is, Cyril and Saurabh have known each other since they were little children, I think. How long y'all have been working together, guys? We suddenly switch this up. It becomes like an Oprah scene where we're counseling Cyril and Saurabh. So guys, tell us, when did you first meet each other?
So, okay, I'll tell my POV and then Suresh, what's his name? Cyril, whatever. So I went for the interview of Channel V, which is like basically they're like, hey, do you want to get paid less money and work? I'm like, yeah, sure. They're like, end of interview, come tomorrow. And then I see this guy with really long hair. And I was like, who's this fucking douchebag? Because he genuinely looked like an asshole. Like, from the first
Cyril.
What's Suresh doing there?
that's fine. That's a better explanation. Cyril looks like a power.
I do.
But Cyril was one of the first few people. Dude, I remember there were two people who spoke to me the first day. I thought that in Channel V, what I'll do is that I'll show up on my first day on time at 9 o'clock, unlike today, in a suit. And I showed up at 9 o'clock in a suit at this, in a media Channel office and Channel V.
Wild.
And the first person to walk in was at 2 o'clock. Okay. And from 9 o'clock till 2 o'clock, I didn't know where my desk was because nobody had told me. So I'm just roaming around the place. And then this one guy comes up to me randomly, this one weird looking dude. And he's like, hey, bhai. I'm like, huh? He's like, तुझे मालूम है कि कैंगरू जब जन्म देते हैं ना तो जो ही वो जो उनका होता है वो अपने पाउच में डाल के उसको ले जाते हैं. And he just walks off. And I was like, what the fuck is that? And it was Alok Kulkarni, who you guys know as this thing. So that is, he's one of the producers at Channel V. And that's the first thing he fucking told me. And I'm like, that's the best introduction line anybody has ever used. And then it turned out he was sitting next to me.
2006, is it? Because I'm sure it's
2005, that's the rule.
Said that, that in those many sentences.
Yeah, still. I can't say it together. Yeah, but Saurabh is, I think the first time we were, of course, what Saurabh left out in a very crucial part
was that,
is that we embarked on Saurabh through a talent show.
Oh, fuck me. Okay.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so it was a talent show where on Channel V, I forgot the name of the show, Pant, and he knows the show, don't pretend you don't.
TV Champions.
So basically the format was, had a bunch of really talented comedians and everyone.
Sounds familiar.
We'd give like a 2 minutes. I think a 2 minute slot on the program, and you basically to get in votes. 1 minute, one minute slot, and you had to get in the most votes from our TV audience, and actually the most popular person in the show ends up getting inducted into Channel V, which was a trap. Which sort of thought it was, hey, this is a cool thing. It was actually a trap. He just wanted like cheap labor, so we made a show around it. but I'm sorry, the main story that I want to talk about is the first time I met Saurabh Pant. Okay, and I was Jose, you I probably told you, Suresh, you and me were on radio at that time.
Yes.
And Saurabh was writing, I think, Suresh, you were there, you knew him from before, because he was writing for a show called the Great Indian Comedy Show. Now,
Suresh has suffered through that. Suresh has. There's another story with Suresh about that, which is great.
Yeah. So I there's a friend, a common friend who was a producer on the show called Anu. And she says, come, you know, we're going to Cafe Coffee Day, which is a cool coffee store that time. You know, and there's these bunch of writers. And I was very enamored by television, right? I was already in the transition of, I want to get in television. So I'm sitting down with all these bunch of guys, and then to my right is Saurabh Pant, who I don't know until that day. And Anu says, yeah, he writes for the Great Indian Comedy Show. I'm like, oh, wow. So you write like comedy, and this is Saurabh's reaction.
Yeah, I write comedy and stuff like that.
He gave me such attitude on that first day. I was like, oh my God, what is these television people? What is this attitude?
Dude, that's the TV Champions. Okay, what happened was that there were all these like 14 people competing. And with varying levels of talent, like I don't think any of us were really talented at all, but we were trying. Okay. And this includes me. So I had done all these comedic sketches, and what happened was, on the final day, I had done reasonably well. Like people were like, especially the production people were coming up and saying, dude, man, oh my God, the funniest is so great and blah, blah, blah. So I had the big reveal where they're going to announce the winners. So we're sitting on this internal, like that seating kind of thing upwards, and the stage is down. So they announce number three. And it's not me. And I'm like, that's cool, man. I mean, come on. Big deal. It's not me.
It's still 2-1.
Yeah, 2-1. Then they announced 2. And I'm like, oh my God, this is so amazing that I've won. I mean, who would have thought this, okay?
Wow.
So, I don't know if anyone confidence, got footage of this, okay? And so they announced 1. And I'm like,
Why? Sunny Deol.
Hey. Oh dear. And they announced somebody else, and I was like, great. And then I had to go like applaud for this person who had won. And then the award was being a writer for Channel V.
Hey, but who was that person who won?
Cyril, do you remember? Tanveer Gill.
Tanveer Gill. Yeah, Gill was one of them.
Was it Tanveer
Gill? I like that it affected both of y'all so much that y'all remember exactly.
Yeah, that was a trick question.
Yeah, I can't remember, you know, honestly, but I'll say it not because we're on his stream right now, but I think Saurabh was the best thing that came out of that show, because the rest of them were this, like, you know, there was no longevity as to what they want to do, but Saurabh was a writer, so it made sense. And weirdly, he was my first responsibility.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
First responsibility.
I'm channeling like, Saurabh is yours now. I'm like, what? Who is this guy? Why is he my responsibility?
So I think we were, other than Suresh, the rest of us were all, I think, jumping into the either the radio or television business at the same time, and then literally like I think a weeks later Suresh jumped into radio. But
no, I was in radio from 2002, man,
in black and white days.
Started only in 2002,
correct? So I was there since 7 months down.
So there's a sort of build up chal rahe there. I was gonna ask Cyril and Saurabh, where were you in 2006? In either the 5th month or the 8th month.
Oh.
These are the certain issues that people encounter when they start doing live streams and all, and then they call close friends onto their shows. I mean, close friend, you can, you know. So I would request the host to allow me to share my screen so that I can share some really amazing media from 2006, either the 5th month or it is the 8th month.
Please.
I don't know the naming format.
this build up is causing a lot of stress right now.
So Saurabh's tech team is going, I'm the host now. So now I can...
Things before you begin. One is that deep fakes are very popular these days.
For sure.
And two, I just want to say on behalf of Cyril and me that I think we've had a good career and I think it's fine.
So, ladies and gentlemen,
justification.
I present to you live on Saurabh Pant's stream what Cyril and Saurabh were doing 2006, either the 5th month
or
the 8th month. Let me just quickly share my.
Hope your PC crashes screen. Right now.
Hold on, I'm going to do it very slowly. Are you able to see my screen?
For Saurabh.
I spent last night finding this.
Make this bigger.
So you know what? The crazy thing about this also is I don't think I even knew Cyril or Saurabh that well at this point, okay? And I was driving home or something, I can't remember, and I see these two idiots on the road, they're asking people, excuse me, bhai saab, time kya hua? And they're dressed like this, okay? They were on the flyover. I remember this so clearly.
Wow.
Here, Bandra somewhere.
Yeah, reclamation.
Towards the station. And I see these guys in women's clothes and huge wigs. I don't know if Saurabh's wearing a wig in this, so this must be natural. But they're just running up to people and saying, time kya hua? So then when I met them, I said, what are you doing? And Cyril so gleefully was telling me, you know, we've decided to dress up like this and ask people, ki time kya hua?
Ahead of their time, yeah. Superb.
Hold on, there's more, don't worry.
Please.
Then I said, Saurabh, please sit in my car. Let me take a picture with you. This is 2006. Saurabh, you aged, your skin, everything is exactly the same. It's really something. I don't know how. And since we're talking about hair and all, those are the old days. I also have pictures of Suresh from when things were slightly different. This is him shooting at Mehboob Studio.
And,
I shouldn't leave myself out. We all had crazy hair when we were younger.
Nice.
This is
nice.
This is one more. And then.
Are you naked also?
Not many of us have aged. Is everything okay, Jose, guys? Are we stuck?
What is happening here?
Yeah.
And Jose, Suresh, why do you have a...
Cyril is asking what is happening here. Cyril is asking. This is what they would do in the office.
Oh, God.
And we wondered why the radio station was not making any money. They'd just be doing this. I have pictures of Cyril just posing in the bathroom randomly. I have no idea why I have this. Just look at this.
That's the bathroom was a nice place, guys. I really like the bathroom.
The station head was in the bathroom at the time. He's still taking pictures. Crazy. So
good old days, I must say.
Yeah. I think I got fired after that. Who is this? Oh, Suresh?
Oh, that's me? My God.
That's you?
Yeah.
You had hair when you were on Red FM?
Yeah, man.
Wow.
It's been a long time.
I think I was recording for Kamala.
Hey, I better close it. I don't know. It might be an outtake. You never know.
That's okay, man.
So that was Saurabh in 2006, either the 5th month or the 8th month. I'm still not sure. And that's Cyril and Saurabh doing their thing.
Thank you.
On flyovers. Bicep time is over.
All right. Let me justify this very quickly.
Sure. Wait,
The channel was going through a period of, lack of sensationalization programming. And Saurabh and I stepped up the game and said, we will get you the kind of, right, be it hate or be it love, We said we will get you those audience, yeah. And hence
they went to the CEO and said, "Sir, हम करेंगे."
Yeah, you know, the funny part was my mother saw this show, okay, and she's asked me like, "Who's the producer on this show?" I didn't have the heart to tell her I was the producer on this show. I said, "Yes, I'm." Saying, "Can you tell them to take you off the show?" It's that bad.
Just politely trying to say, "My son cannot cross dress. It's not happening."
By the way, we've not even covered this amazing thing. So Sharib Hashmi, who's like now a very famous actor, and he was a writer at Channel V. So he and Cyril did a character on a show called Basement. I don't know if anyone can find this, called Shakira and Beyonce.
Oh, damn.
Okay, like Shakira and Beyonce. Yeah, yeah. And then I came on as a guest for, and I was playing another. So all of us were just cross-dressing that time. And then I came on as, what is the character? Some weird, another weird, terrible pun on some pop star.
Yeah. If you were in television in those days, you definitely cross-dressed at some point.
Yeah. There was Neil Bhopalan as well, and he was very enamored by us as three beauties and Joey Pandey.
Maybe you've got to stop dressing like that, you know.
I still do. It's nice. It's fulfilling at the end of it. But yeah, Channel V was that. You know, that was the culture of programming. I think that's what people are doing right now, right? I mean, is that what people are doing in YouTube now is what we were doing in Channel V in the early 2000s. Yeah, so we didn't have YouTube in 2000. It came out in 2005 onwards. But, you know, we were doing all that kind of stuff and relevant. Sort of still dresses, cross-dresses like
you know
that.
What I miss the most about Channel V? You guys used to do the English, Hindi songs cut to English
visuals. Yeah, masala mix.
Bomb. And yeah, I wanted to join Channel V first, actually. I remember that. I remember thinking, oh man, Channel V. Then MTV happened.
Yeah, Saurabh was the traitor. He was in MTV.
Yeah, I know. But I remember back then there was this whole, I remember speaking to Cyril once, and I was so new to and green to the whole thing. I think when he was friends with you, I was like, dude, is this allowed? And he's like, are you fucking stupid? I'm like, should we talk to these MTV people? He's like, dude, nobody gives a fuck.
And then a few years down the line, everybody from Channel V and MTV had worked in each other's companies at some point or the other.
Yeah,
the
yeah.
whole TV
yeah,
industry.
But, well, I would like to interject over here and interrupt your nice English music channel cup. English music channels cup, you know, friendship and remembering
Milan,
all the
Milan.
Hey, listen. Yeah. Maybe Vijay Tata bhi, ETC channel.
Oh,
ke bhi.
Suresh
is the original. Suresh is the first
Vijay. And I was the number one channel. I mean, number one anchor in that channel.
Yeah. No, they told me.
Because
him
I was the only
one channel.
Yeah. Suresh created the term Vijay, guys. It's been that. That's when
actually, Suresh, which channel was that for?
ETC.
Oh, my God. And back in those days, Suresh was doing like 300 characters on TV and all.
Live.
He would go out of the frame like that and come back as a different person. I don't know how he did it.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll just take a couple of super chats and then I got to talk to Suresh about this thing. Deep Sleep Wizard J says, Phoda Kasta Starta. What is that? I don't even know what that means. What does that mean?
Concrete,
not exactly sure. Deep Wizard J is from my YouTube community. Sorry, somebody I recognize. He says weird things to me also. So this is normal for him.
Hey man, why do you have to claim him, you know? I mean, why are you claiming people? I mean, what is this like?
Listen, fiefdom? It's tough now. It's a pandemic scene and you have Saurabh Pant fans who are either from the 5th month or the 8th month. And then you have, you know, different... It's like when Suresh Menon raids your channel, you're screwed.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I have Arnab Banerjee who keeps coming. Okay. I don't know if he's ever come on your fucking channel. Okay. Just want to say this. Okay?
Even I don't know.
Thanks, Arnab Banerjee has given money for your bills. Anirudh Agnihotri, Suresh Jose Cyril are great. Kanmasti is the first podcast I listen to. Please talk about the Kanmasti origin story. Okay, we'll talk about this. I'll just take two more super chats and then I think yesterday also we spoke about that in that Gujarati thing that we did, which both of us were surprised to find ourselves in.
Yeah.
Jose is messaging me, are you on this? I'm like, yeah, I think I am on this. Yeah.
Hey, nice.
Manan's stream you're talking about.
Oh, yeah. Manan's
this is
stream.
The Comedy Factory, 9 years. They did a 9-hour stream.
Wow.
Yeah. And they raise money for charity and all. Which, I mean, awesome, who can trust? Who can trust them, you know? I just want to put it out there. Please don't trust people like Manandesa. He's a good guy. Okay. Alok Barla says, thanks, Saurav, for making it happen. It's good Jose turned up for the show today. Else, I would have come to his place and sandwiched his face. That's a funny part.
I think that's a compliment.
Very funny.
Yeah.
Sandwiches in your face.
Yash N says, Kanmasti never gets old. It doesn't even feel like you're listening to a podcast. I don't know what prompted you to record those conversations. But Jose, you're brilliant. Very conveniently, he's left out Cyril and Suresh. Just want to mention.
Yeah, yeah.
That let me just be very clear. Know, these are Jose. paid fans of Jose. Yeah.
I want to clear one fact out here, is that Jose is on a teleprompter while Suresh and I are normally doing it spontaneous. Yeah.
Shovik Bhattacharya, Saurapan should be appreciated as he was able to bring Jose, Cyril and Suresh apart from Kanmasti. But it's Kanmasti only, you know? Like,
he's got a point. Fans. He's a true fan. He knows that we are unable to do meet together for our own podcast. He's like, wow, they met for another podcast? I said, so yeah.
Sorry, there's a lot of super chat. Anirudh Agnihotri again. Jose, crack up listening to music because I hear the misheard lyrics. And of the real ones at times. Siddharth Samant, Kanmasti forever. Gahawde, Hitesh, Saurabh, what's your reviews on Yeezy, Foam Runner and QNTM? I don't know, man. This is continuing from Kamba's conversation. Okay, let's ask Suresh this question. Suresh, what's your review on Yeezy, Foam Runner and QNTM? What's your latest cops?
Yeah.
Cool.
Very profound. Very profound. Very
well, it's not fitting.
Saurabh,
what is that? Some detergent? Was it then detergent? A lot of foam and all that.
It's some shoes, apparently. Do Cyril and Jose know? You guys look like you're more.
Yeah. I got a pair.
Look, I don't leave the house, so I don't need shoes.
Okay, Sonal Bhadoria says, you mean juice? This still cracks me up. Big fan of Jose. Great panel. Thanks for the stream. Appreciate it, Sonal. DJ Rajput. Pictures so scandalous, Jose had hidden them. Says DJ Rajput. Nikhil Puchil says, they were hidden. Oh, fuck yeah. They were hidden, right?
They were hidden.
Holy shit.
No, but that's because they were in a folder that I just hidden everything anyway. I don't explain this. Why are you making me explain this?
Nikhil Uchil, Jose just loved the Arnab printer customer support video. So yeah, it was
fun. What fun.
Manish Nalawade says, hi Suresh, loved your Kamla Ka Hamla bit on the radio. Have you ever been recognized as the signal by a into quotation marks Kamla?
But not as Kamla. But they
recognize. Oh, I you have forced my hand here. I'm gonna have to tell a story about how Suresh being recognized on the roads. Okay, this is now again. I say 2006, 2008 in the fifth month or the eighth month. I'm
you
not
need to give
sure.
Him a calendar.
But so you know how people are now the. Because of the internet and Instagram and YouTube and people going crazy viral on social media, they're extremely recognizable, okay? But people in television and movies know that there's a very different kind of recognizable when it comes to television stars and people who've worked in movies. I mean, this is my opinion, my personal opinion, but I do feel that it's true. So walking with Suresh, okay, on the road, oh my God, it is insane. You do that now. I mean, thankfully now we are not allowed to walk on the road like that. But Suresh, okay, this is me walking with Suresh on the road. He's just walking with his phone or whatever, and people are like, Suresh, sir. Fucking, they start going around you like that. Yeah, oh, this, that, and all. And I remember I had just started doing MTV. So people were like, "Arey, Shakib, ye Pragya." They didn't say Shakib in those days.
No, I remember they called me Roshan Abbas and they called you Shakib.
Very funny. So I remember and at that point I was like, wow, man, I'm on TV and stuff, and people are recognizing me when I go to buy bread in my chappals and saying, "Hey, chutiya chappal pehnta hai," and all. But Suresh was on another level, man. And I remember thinking, "Oh, I aspire for that level of recognizability."
So it's pretty
See,
much
kitna
the same
modestly
thing.
Better over there, but yes,
but
yes,
it's pretty much the same thing. I go on the streets walking like this, very casually. People are still staring at me, and they, "Hey, sala paisa nahi diya abhi tak." and they all start running behind me. So.
Fair enough. I don't have these problems, guys, so it's nice. But my mom the other day didn't know who I was, so it's going backwards for me.
Hey, but now things are flipped around. Things are flipped around. A lot of people whom I meet nowadays, they come and meet me and they shake hands out of respect. You know, they give respect to elders, and then they say, "Hey, listen, just tell Jose that we really like him a lot." So I become his. Not only fans pass on messages through me to him, also clients, they sort of call me up and they say, "Mr. Menon, we are doing this project. Can you call up Jose and speak to him?" What?
Yeah, funny.
And this is an out of work actor that they call up and say that, you know, please, can you just speak to Jose? And maybe you both can do something, but we want him solo. Now, to only it was solo. Now they say, yeah, now they say that, you know, sir, we are calling from blah, blah, blah agency. And do you know Jose well? I say, yeah. Then I'm thinking,
hey, you're not forwarding the calls, though, Suresh.
What? So I'm forwarding everything. You phone nahi uthata na, iske liye main tere ko phone karke batata hu.
Theek hai.
So then they say, okay, Jose to theek hai. Can you tell Jose to put Chloe on line with us? So now it's not even Jose.
Yeah.
Even my I'm happy with this transition, actually. I think, yeah, Jose's time is done. At least you're lucky, you know, Suresh, you were like getting client calls. I was the photographer, because me and Jose normally hang out a lot because we stay close to each other, right? So they're like, hey, guys, come. And then, hey, Sil, you'll take a photo. I mean, they didn't say Sil. They're like, hey, Chokra, you'll take a photo of me and Jose. And I'll be like, fine, sure, no problem. I would take bad photos purposely. I mean, that was my only, make sure Jose's face was blurred.
But I remember one thing very clearly, a little bit of serious talk, that way back in 2004 or allegedly 2006, fifth month or the eighth month, somewhere in between those two months. I think Jose told me once, I remember this clearly even before we started conversation, that internet is going to be the next big thing.
What rubbish I said.
I remember him telling this to me, and I said, "Hey, computer mein kaun dekhiya?"
You know, Suresh, I remember this was because I was trying to download porn, man.
See, whatever reasons, but you saw the future through porn.
True, that's true.
Yeah. But yeah, I have on the internet as data, Suresh. Internet was the name of one of his neighbors.
Yeah.
Quite possible.
But you know what? I still have like these little video recordings and all from when we were in radio, and we were on some level trying to make vines, I think. Or we were trying to make like videos for the internet, but of course we had like 56 kbps connection and we had jobs and also and that was not part of the job description. But I have these really terrible videos where Cyril is pretending to be someone from The Godfather and all, and
what
is going on.
Yeah.
But you're recording a lot of those for YouTube now, no?
What? Those same videos, the low quality videos.
We're recycling it. We shot those in like VGA cameras.
I have 3GP files on my computer. I don't know if anybody's old enough to know what a 3GP file is. But
yeah. No. Anyone who doesn't know MTNL will not know 3GP.
I know the cardboard file that I still use.
But I think that's an interesting thing, right? I mean, the evolution of like, I think a lot of questions come to Saurabh and a lot of questions come to Jose and Suresh. It's like, you know, how is it so, you know, easy for you all to shoot content? And I think that the interesting part is that it's always been part of like your DNA. I know Saurabh is always in channel, be enthusiastic about shooting content. Jose is always, and to a certain level, I think between the two of you all, that's the only reason that I actually forayed into, you know, being in front of the camera compared to being behind as a producer. But I think because this, and then wine and all these things were just interesting transitions for us at the end of it. But, yeah, I just wanted to add to this conversation. That's it.
Cyril was the worst producer ever.
No.
I don't doubt that he made us. Yes, he definitely. He used to say, you know, in the middle of the show, he would say stuff like, "I made you. Just you do this line. Huh? You
really, Cyril?
Like, what the fuck?" And then he would laugh. Then he would go back to being serious. So I'm not sure if he was being serious or not. So for many years, I also told people the same thing, but Ram Gopal Verma had come to the studio. I don't know how many times, how many places I've told this story, but this is a good spot as any. Ram Gopal Verma has come to the studio to be interviewed. I think he was doing what was it? Sarkar?
Sarkar must be Sarkar.
The older one, I think.
No, older than that. We are very old.
Rath.
So
they weren't. Jose wasn't born.
Yeah. And for some reason, he didn't like the idea that there were so many young people around. And you know how when Radio Rao was starting, they hired everyone was like, you know, so I think he didn't really like that. He was not feeling the seriousness of it or whatever. But he came into the studio and he refused to speak. He didn't say anything. Imagine I had a person in my studio who I'm trying to interview, who's not opening his mouth. So I was doing things like, okay, guys, I think he's going to answer. He's moved his head from side to side and Cyril is standing there behind me taking calls and shit, okay? I don't know. It was like a scene from the Twilight Zone. I don't even know how this transpired, but I was like, man, this is so uncomfortable. So I started doing commentary over him being in the studio saying, Ram Gopal Varma is here. All right, now his manager has moved from this side to this side. We're going to take some questions. Everybody call the number, Cheche, Nautin Panch, call us now. And the calls start coming in. Okay. Awkwardness happening between the call. Nothing is happening. And all Cyril is like nothing is happening when he's picking up calls. Hello. Ek second main puchta hu. So he puts the phone next to him. So he says, Ram, this caller has a question. I'm just wondering if you want to answer it. Just keep in mind the context here is that Ram Gopal Varma has not said a word to anybody in the studio till now. No one.
Cyril, respect.
No one. Cyril is going, so will you take this question? The person on the line is asking, aapke beech mein aur Urmila ke beech mein kuch ho raha tha kya? And I'm like, motherfucker, what are you doing? This is already extremely uncomfortable. You're going to fuck. How am I supposed to continue this interview? So awkward silence. Cyril's got the phone to his chest like this. They're staring into each other's eyes. And Ram Gopal Varma says, Cyril says, nahin, usne kaha ki nahin, wo nahin answer nahin deta. Thank you. Chalo, bye. And he puts the phone. And then we're all just standing around awkwardly in the studio like this. The song gets over. Hello everybody, welcome. Da, da, da. Ram Gopal Varma in the studio. He's not answering questions. I don't know what's happening. Blah blah blah. Ding dong. Pray, man. Then I woke up and I was like, I'm here only. I'm still in the studio with them.
Yeah, to summarize it was like, you know, putting subtitles on a radio show. That's literally what that was. It was like Jose was the subtitle guy reading out Ram Gopal.
It's amazing how much Cyril didn't care about anything. Like, he just didn't care. He was like, fuck it. The idea of screening calls is to screen calls.
Yeah, but Jose,
Cyril was like, what's that? Yeah, let me just ask him directly whatever you said to me in my ear.
I mean, in hindsight, he was being, it was just such a, you know, we dead. So that now between the three of us, between Suresh, Jose and me, I think we were probably, you know, power pack team, right? And it was always, there was no such thing as dead silence. We were not used to it. Sort of, you should know this even. Yeah. And
dead air, no?
Suddenly we have dead air with Ram Gopal Varma, who was a big director at that time. I mean, still is, I presume. I'm not sure.
He was huge man at that time. I was shitting myself.
Like, so suddenly there's dead air. We didn't know what to do. So we just like, we did what we did and went at it. But he complained.
He complained to whom?
Yeah. To Aajtak, who was our parent company.
Oh, man. Time. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, assholes like, you hired.
But Aajtak, I loved Aajtak because Aajtak now, they were the most beautiful set of people that we had. Okay. Because we're part of India Today.
Yeah.
And Aajtak, these are the guys who were interviewing like hitmen and at the same time, the Australian cricket team. And, you know, so it was so enamored by them. That, and then they come and they are laughing. You know, like, Ram ne bola aisa, and Jose is like, we tried our best. And then we all played Counter-Strike. Listen, after that. It was fine.
Oh, yeah, man. That was the best day.
But come to think of it now that Cyril mentioned it, though, back in the day, I remember we used to complain about the news also. But in retrospect, it was way better. They were actually doing like some serious stories.
I remember the first time we had to do audio bites. You know, Aajtak did this tie up with us because we're sister companies and said, you know, we can give you audio bites of some of the interviews we're doing. And I remember as a producer in the station, I was like, okay, you have to tag it on. So this guy, I meet this guy who's now a really big person in television. He says, okay, we're going to go and meet, we're doing a thing on the underworld. And we're going to meet a hitman. I don't know. I'll send somebody.
I'm not well today. My company.
coming for this interview at the end of it. But luckily, like, that didn't happen, and we met the Australian cricket team who had come down or something like that. But it was fun. It was a good experience.
But sometimes these guys, like, who are in interviews, and I find it very weird, like, people like Ram Gopal Verma and all the rest of these people, there's a bit of a power dynamic.
Oh, yeah.
Where
yeah,
you
yeah.
are effectively exploiting the power dynamic to essentially try and fuck over the other person, which is very strange. I'm not saying that that's what Ram Gopal Verma did, but there are a lot of them where they're like, listen,
no,
I'm...
It. That
yeah.
It.
yeah, it wasn't. He's a great person. yeah.
Yeah.
Suresh has got the expression of a guy who has a lot to say about all this.
Insides.
Bro, the stuff that's... Suresh tells us, see, people say, why do we edit Kaan Masti and all? Because, oh
yeah, yeah.
my God.
So, Saurabh, I would keep your hand on the mute button really fast. Just be ready.
You have the replay buffer.
Ram Gopal Verma was always a debauched person, you know. So thing is that his ego was much bigger than him. And after, I think, during Aag, the ego got better of him because he wanted to replicate, you know, his attitude was Shole. I will make that film and they'll remember Ram Gopal Verma's Shole more than the original Shole. And that's, I mean, he was right in that sense. People still remember. So he's that egoistical who...
Oh,
now has toned down, but he still knows how he can get into your mind. He's like another Mahesh Bhatt in the industry. He can get into your mind. If you people are really close to him, they can get into your heads and minds and, you know, and manipulate people. Mahesh Bhatt is a nice person. Very fatherly figure. Very fatherly figure. And... what?
Wait, I'm so a little confused. What were we talking about?
Ram Gopal Verma.
So I heard a butt somewhere.
So what yeah. butt? I didn't say anything about Mahesh Bhatt. Oh God, no Mahesh Bhatt.
Oh that I
saw
the asses.
He gives out threats
yeah.
also by Mahesh Bhatt.
No, we are talking about like interviews and awkwardness and radio stations.
No. So all these people, they had a lot of egos. They used to carry with them. They still carry with them. And when they met somebody, for example, somebody starting off, there as Saurabh rightly said, that power game. Main Ram Gopal Verma hu. I can't talk to a whole day. You know, so a lot of times I used to face this when I was in ETC, when I started off. A lot of people used to say, we want to meet who's going to be the anchor on the show.
Just to see. Ki, achha
yeah,
hai
then
ki.
I used to be put in front and I used to be standing like this and looking at him. Ki, no, and they pura upar niche aisa dekh raha hai, what nonsense.
Oh my God,
seriously,
terrible.
Complete
well, thankfully, it wasn't
you know?
At that level.
And these are the same people who talk about, you know, whatever they're talking now, it's quite annoying. So
no, but you know that thing is there in a lot of people. Like something that you also know, Saurabh had
shock.
That. Saurabh had that same attitude as well. You know, I remember in Chanvi when he was in his peak of his stardom, and he's like, I can't talk to this person. I refuse to talk to them. And I'm like, but Saurabh, he's your boss. We need to chat with him.
Hey guys, but I must just put it out there, you know, just for the sake of it. I think one of the first guys in this film industry, in this industry, media industry, who interviewed Kangana Ranaut for a first film. I just want to put it out.
Really?
There. Yeah.
Wow.
Or gangster.
Yeah.
No, but she's actually a fun interview. I mean, forget everything else. She's actually a fun interview.
Now, those days, and this was a film made from Mahesh Bhatt's camp, and I still remember her being this really innocent young little thing. Was put into this big bad world, you know. She's in the wolf of the industry, and she's over there. And the way she was, I mean, I got a damn good interview with her in Chinese Ojo. It was a lot of fun. But man, now going back to those days and watching things happening around now, it's amazing. Respect that woman for that journey that she has done.
Yo,
without
she's
any
made some really last few tweets. People should check out. She's made some really explosive like. Tweets and she's asked for protection and stuff and I think she should be given that.
Oh shit, I mean, let me see. I'll offer her my protection.
Suresh, jaldi jao.
But I
no, serious.
But nothing can
Saurabh is like, what is happening to my podcast?
Where,
this
Saurabh?
Is what the podcast is. It's just like...
so basically, Kangana, but Kangana is a damn good actress. She's a fantastic, fabulous actress, and I hope she continues doing what she's good at also.
She's very professional in a way. And when we worked with her for a bunch of things, I feel like there's a very high level of professionalism and she's very like focused on what she's doing in particular, which I think is really great, right? It helps you manage things a lot better. There's no joke coming out of this. That's a serious moment. Sorry, that was my serious moment.
Okay.
Saurabh knows what he's doing. He's just like, karne do baat.
Who started off this conversation about Ram Gopal Varma, Paul the person?
Yeah, Suresh, who, like, I don't want to get into any controversies, but Suresh, who else is debauched in Bollywood? Please tell us.
I think it would be easier to answer who is not.
Yeah, we come back after 4 hours. It's going to be a long conversation.
Yeah, that's it. Who's not?
Dude, last time we were doing the podcast, okay, what used to happen was that Suresh would be like, this person, is and then his internet would conk off. And he's like, I was saying this person, and again, his internet would
Basically, Saurabh, we figured what the problem is. Connection was people like Mahesh Bhatt and all are standing outside and they're pulling out the internet wire as soon as he starts talking about it.
I don't think so. In coefficient of the universe.
Okay, I want to talk about Great Indian Comedy Show, but again, we've got a couple of what's it called? What is this
Super
called?
Chats.
Super chats.
Sagar Hotchandani, great surname. Kanmasti OP, thanks Saurabh for getting them together. Not completed without Gendul discussion though. I don't know what is Gendul.
Gendul, let me explain, please. Gendul is at one.
I cannot do this.
No, please.
Hey, Jose, can you get me a cup of tea too?
This is not fair. Look at that guy. He's trying to avoid the actual thing. Gendul is that lovely, thin little sliver of shit that comes from your bum. It looks like an earthworm. So it's a sliver. It's a nice little thing. The Genduls come out in a smooth manner, you know that you're having a good day. So I'm also now going to start Gendul reading very soon.
That's nice. He puts his finger on the Gendul. Huh? That's why he does it.
Yeah.
But why are so many Genduls coming out of you, Cyril? I think you might actually have worms.
Yeah. See, the thing is...
You have to then go and get it tested also. And this would be good. But if Genduls are coming out, it's a good thing. Yeah. And this
What was your Gendul today? Suresh, can you do his reading today? Or Saurabh's Genduls?
This is everything that gets edited out from Kanmasti, basically.
Dude, by the way, this guy gave $5 to ask this question.
Wow.
You have to answer it now. Now you have to answer.
So also, let me explain. Gendul, you know, when you also, the main important thing is once you finish shitting, you feel that, you know, there's something left behind. And then after some half an hour later, you say, okay, let me take a try again. And you go and sit in the on the pot and then... what comes out is a sliver of shit that comes out. And that's exactly
Suresh,
what it
you need. You need more liquids in your diet, I think.
Yeah.
Hey, shit, something happened to your face, man.
Yeah. You know, you know the story of Hansel and Gretel and how they leave the breadcrumbs in the forest, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Suresh leaves the crumbs. They're called the little crumbs.
Suresh is like a human snail. Everywhere he goes, he leaves that little layer line. And people are like the witch is like, hey, is this Hansel and Gretel? No, it's just Suresh Menon who's in the forest.
So to be very honest with you, and this is something we want to discuss in Kanmasti, Suresh actually invented GPS, but it's not global positioning satellite, it's Gendul positioning satellite.
Wow.
Yeah.
Thank you guys.
I think it was originally called Gendul positioning susu because he used to also in the front, he used to leave a mark on both sides just in case like there was dryness later.
And also keep away other, I mean, ferocious animals and all won't come closer.
Yeah. So, Jose, how sick are you of this particular conversation?
No, I'm used to this all the time. In my mind, I was editing this. You know, Saurabh, how sometimes you're in a video and while you're in the video, you're editing it for later. So, I know that when this discussion starts, I'll cut it. But these grown men, we cannot stop discussing Genduls and Lenduks and all.
So much of
Lenduk is a Gendul only.
Gendul ka chota bhai.
I'm sorry. Suresh is the Gendul and Lenduk connoisseur.
Yeah.
He has a museum. Saurabh should watch that that documentary that Vice did about poop wine.
Yeah.
You know about this?
Yeah. And Saurabh loves wine.
Medicinal properties, Saurabh. And they show you. You know how the guy makes pani puri? Vaisa hi same type ka handi he uses. And he's putting poop in it and he's mixing it with rice wine. And the Vice reporter drinks it also. I mean, it sounds really disgusting, but it's actually a really interesting documentary.
Yeah. It tastes a little woody. Right, Suresh?
Yeah. Little. It depends on what you eat in the previous night or
too much cinnamon.
When you collected the poop.
Yeah. Hey, I just want to clarify one thing while Jose plays this. Oh, I don't like chatting about game rules thing. Let me just.
I love it. I never said I don't like it.
In radio days, okay, Jose used to force me in the middle of an office. What? The two of us would get up and put our hands up and says, "Who else loves caca?" This is every day when we had clients and people and everyone showing up in our office.
I
we
do would not stand up this.
With our hands up not. And he said, "Chal chal, abhi karte, abhi karte, sir, abhi karte." And then
I
put our
hands up. I vaguely remember this.
So don't like, I'm a keeper of secrets.
No, we I think days where we felt like, you know, we're young and we should show people how young and cool we are. And also we were like, I love caca in the middle of an office with, you know.
Also to be fair people. To Jose, maybe they're talking about caca. They were huge Rajesh Khanna fans.
Yeah.
Jose.
Oh yeah.
Fair. You know, I like how Jose is like, you know, we were trying to be cool, so let's talk about shit, because that's the like that's what divine is also like. Hey, main tatti khaya kal raat ko teri maa. That's the level of cool. It's like get dol, hey, tere maa ki fan dol. Like that's the level of cool.
We're big fans Lendo. Of his music.
Dude, but by the gendol and lendok is great words for rap. Those are really great words for rap. Gendo, Lendo, oh.
Usme ne kaha uske ghar ke upar tar mein hu Akshay Kumar, tune kiya mere upar var. Lendo, pwa! Lendo.
Oh,
it's I see it.
It's great. Yeah. Nice. I think somebody who's ambitious in the chat, please cut that edit and release it as Gendo, Lendo edit.
Gendo.
Okay, a couple of super chats and then we got to, I've been wanting to, great in a comedy show somebody's actually seen. Barun Chanda, Jose and Suresh, appreciate both of you guys for the work you guys have done. Discovered Jose with the KRK MTV Desh Drohi video and Suresh from the Great Indian Comedy Show. Suresh's Jaggu Dadda was...
That's how they discovered me. Great. Jaggu Dadda. Man, the craziest thing about... I remember when we started working with Suresh, the craziest thing... I mean, it's not a good idea to close your eyes around Suresh, but when we first started working together, I remember thinking, man, there are people who do voices and then there are people who really become those voices. And if you close your eyes around Suresh, again, not a good idea, but close your eyes when he's doing the voices, man. You know how sometimes when we're doing shows and stuff, they'll get one person to do the VO for different characters and you can tell it's the same person doing the VO for all the different characters. But this guy, you can't, man. It's crazy. Everybody close your eyes and now we will transform you and take you. Saurabh, you're the host. You don't have to do anything. we will now have Jaggu Dadda. Jaggu Dadda. Everyone close your eyes, okay? If you're watching this, close your eyes and listen to Jaggu Dadda.
ये बेड़ो अपना क्या क्या सुबह सुबह कान मस्ती सुनने का घर पे वॉचमैन को नहाने का हाथ सैनिटाइज करने का मास्क विस्क पहनने का अपने आप को संभालने का शेजारी के पास नहीं जाने का किसी से हाथ नहीं मिलाने का नमस्ते करके निकल जाए वटक ना का बास
अभी रेंज देख नाउ सचिन तेंदुलकर
यस सर डेफिनेटली अपना मास्क पहनने का मास्क कभी नहीं निकालने का और प्लीज प्लीज फॉर हेवन सेक अगर अपने को लॉन्ग इनिंग्स खेलना है तो हाथ को सैनिटाइज करते रहने का बस
माय फेवरेट थिंग टू डू टू सुरेश वुड बी ना आई वुड ऑन द रेडियो आई'd be like हाय जग्गू दादा हाउ आर यू एंड देन ही'd स्टार्ट डूइंग हिज जैकी श्रॉफ वॉइस वेरी सीरियसली एंड देन हाफवे थ्रू आई'd be like अरे सर हम क्या कर रहे इधर
या आई लव दिस ओके दिस इज व्हेन यू गाइस यूज्ड टू डू दैट सैटरडे रेडियो शो more. And then I spoke to either Jose or Cyril or whoever. And he goes, like, yeah, you know, the channel also needs to make money. And I'm like, that's a good point.
Yeah. I think if you need to know first, where the Kaan Masti original story comes from, I think Jose can, it literally
that's
was.
That's probably what it was.
What Jose used to do? He used to make me do Anjan Daruwala, loosely based on Bejan Daruwala, the late Bejan Daruwala. And I used to be in the full, Are Aisa Hai? And I used to do that full Parsi accent. अगर तुमने ये किया तो वैसा तुम्हारा फ्यूचर का भरोसा नहीं है एंड सडनली अरे सडनली सैफ अली खान साहब आए एंड देन आई टोल्ड फ्रॉम ऐसा है ए ड्यूड क्या चल रहा है अरे ठाकुर साहब यू नो एंड देन बाय द टाइम इट केम टू ठाकुर साहब इट यूज्ड टू बी समथिंग लाइक दिस
मैंने जानता है कि
एंड यूज्ड टू लाफ आई यूज्ड टू गेट ऑल द वॉइसेस मिक्स्ड अप मैन इट वाज लाइक
इट वाज टू फनी मैन आई थिंक फ्रॉम अ रेडियो पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू व्हाट वुड हैपन इज स्पेशली व्हेन दीस टू गाइस वुड गेट इन द स्टेशन इनटू द स्टूडियो I think everyone will leave their, you know, their stations and will all be in the studio just watching them live, you know, because that was like the most entertaining aspect of radio back then for us, you know. And everything was like, there was no scripts, right? Unlike most things back then, everything was like, we don't know what's going to happen. So of course, I was always on standby, someone on standby for the, you know, the, you know, the go off air button in case something.
we weren't even using the delay, no?
Yeah, we had a 5-second delay. I don't know what that was supposed to do for us.
Which we never set up. We never used it also. Oh, yeah. Bro, you guys have to, I don't know if I've even told anyone this story, but so, you know, I was so excited. I had literally like a soundboard, a living soundboard in my studio. Suresh Menon, you just say anything to him and he can do the voice. And my mind was like going all over the place. I mean, as we went along, we did crazy shit. Like, I started using his voice for soundboards and pretending that he was either Sachin Tendulkar and telling people that they're getting to really speak with the real person. Okay. So this one time we did it was super early in the morning, and yeah, it was Shah Rukh Khan's birthday or something. So we were like, welcome everyone. Good morning today. Nowhere else, kisi aur ke paas nahi hai ye interview. We've got Shah Rukh Khan in the studio with us. If you want to speak to him, call us right now. Chacha, Nautin, Panch, dang, 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 dong. Phone lines have gone crazy, okay? Everyone is like, mere ko Shah Rukh Khan se baat karna chahiye. So this one lady sounded really gullible. So I picked up and I said, yes, ma'am, he's right here. But ma'am, it's because I knew ki Suresh, I don't know how long Suresh should be able to keep it up. So I said, he's very tired, but I'm bahut kaam karke aaya hai. So if he's being a little odd, I'll just train DJ, you just wish him happy birthday, jaldi karna. I just wanted to get that, like, you know, that glee and all. So I put her on the line and we had not set up our delays or anything. So usually if you make a mistake on radio, you can press a button and those 4 seconds before you press the button will be stitched together. And those 4 seconds or 8 seconds or however much delay you put into it can be, like, you know, taken out. So, even bigger idiot that I was is that, you know, usually you're supposed to record these things. You do any phone call, you should be recording them. I think we talked about this on Manan's stream also, you know, that people say the weird things, they don't know what's happening and blah, blah, blah. So, so now I'm the song is going on and I'm telling Suresh, you have to pretend to be Shah Rukh Khan and don't fuck around. No jokes and all. You give it that whole, like, hey man, really Shah Rukh Khan and all. And he's like, yeah, don't worry, bro. Kar denge and all. And
hey, song gets that's my best impersonation also. I remember this.
Debatable. So then, so the song gets over. I go on saying, guys, and I'm very seriously, I'm selling this and I'm saying, guys, in the studio with us, Shah Rukh Khan. I press the applause button, add the sound effects and everything. I was going crazy. Suresh comes on going, and very subtle, like, hey, hello.
Hello, I'm Shah Rukh Khan.
And as you know how people are so gullible with fake news today, now it makes sense. You know what I mean? Now I look back and think, are you okay? That makes sense. But this lady says, oh my God, Shah Rukh ji, main aapka bahut bada fan hu. Now, literally 5 seconds into this conversation, Suresh has gone from being the semi-serious Shah Rukh Khan to, hey, just like fully screwing around now, okay? And he's saying stuff like, hey, mujhe dar nahi lag raha hai. And he's doing all these puns and all. And then this lady, okay, live on the air, she says, excuse me, you're fucking with us? And I shat myself. We just started our careers and all.
I'll never forget that tone. I'll never forget the tone.
The tone changed. The tone changed.
She said, "Tum log, pyar to Shah Rukh Khan ko itni hai, tum log chutiya bana rahe public ko."
No, she said, I remember, you know why I remember, she said, are you fucking with us?
Yeah,
because she said tum log chutiya bana rahe, are you fucking with us? Because Suresh has come back, okay? There's a 2-second pause. And he says, hey, nahi, ma'am, no ducking, no ducks. Ah. And we press the button and go into song.
So, yeah, that's the worst.
A bad save that was.
What the hell? And then after then, that day, no more live calls.
But then Jose, we came back on and they are, pata nahi, that lady had some problems, issue, unka connection theek nahi tha. Lagta unke ghar mein bahut chitiya tha.
yeah. Because she said chuti. Stupid. Stupid shit we got into, that's terrible.
Yeah. Radio was a fun and dangerous place.
Could you get ever like into like legal trouble or something like that or what?
Back then, there were no norms set, so I think we got away with a lot of loops.
There was a point where you'd say, ki, bro, we're screwing around, and you know, like, that was really Shah Rukh Khan. So yeah, there was the disclaimers and all would happen.
Yeah, but that was around the time when we had to then suddenly switch over from, you know, हमारे पास Shah Rukh Khan के लिए, then we had to say, और हमारे साथ है Maruk Khan, you know. Uh-huh. So, on the names in. Then Sachin became Kachin. Yeah. Amitabh became Kavitabh.
Or we would work around, say, instead of saying his full name, we just say SRK.
Yeah.
I think the initial part is when radio came back, right? And we were part of that first wave of private radio stations, right? I think even the government or per se, whoever is responsible for broadcast didn't realize. So I think they were watching these shows and saying, acha, let's make this a new rule. Okay, let's make this a new rule. So it took years before they started incorporating what can and what can't we do. So I think there were fun years, and of course there were norms. I don't think we ever crossed the line.
I'm not liking this discussion. It makes it sound like we did something illegal. We did not do anything illegal.
No, nothing illegal. Of course not.
I mean, there was one show where you were literally burping and eating pizza for an hour, talking about cricket commentary.
Oh, I'll never forget that. Cyril, I'll tell you all about that. That was 2003, the final between India and Australia in South Africa. And we decided to go live. Cyril said, let's do live. We'll do live. I'll call for pizzas and all that stuff. And then we can have fun. Beer
all the also. Dumbest ideas start like that. Let's do it live. Saurabh, I hope you're listening.
No. But the thing is, I think it was my first cricket commentary that I ever got to do on air. And we started off, and I still remember this particular over that Zahir Khan started off bowling to Matthew Hayden. And he came in, first ball, Matthew Hayden misses. And then we both are on air and I'm Sachin, whatever. Oh, yeah, bahut achhi gain. Then suddenly what happened was Zahir Khan went up to Matthew Hayden and started abusing.
Yeah.
Okay, so there was something happened between them. So then I said, they shouldn't be doing this. They shouldn't annoy the batsman. Abhi to out hoga hi nahi. And we're having fun. And then what happened was mayhem, as you already know. In between that, somewhere... So when Sachin was batting, Sachin got out and Cyril was on air, I was on air, Jose was on air. So I said, I feel bad for poor Sachin. And when I said poor Sachin, Cyril, even I feel bad for him, 200 crore under his bum. I really feel bad for poor Sachin. And then we started laughing so much. And then in between, Jose is asking me, "Hamare paas hai Kachin, so what's the strategy, Kachin?" And we were English those days. So Kachin comes on air and says, "Oh, it's a very good idea. They will score around 400 plus runs. And then what will you all do? We'll lose, Ray. Go enjoy it."
Dude, I have a feeling I've listened to this, by the way. Either did you guys do this again at some stage, or was this the only time?
Because it became a standard. A couple of times.
I've heard it three only. Yeah.
It was damn funny, dude. This is literally like, you know how comedians do that whole thing right now of, like, I realized that all the formats have been done in some way before, no matter what it is. Right? Yeah. Like, so right
even
now,
by
the time
we were doing it, they're already been done a thousand times. Yeah, yeah.
So everything, like whether it's like live streaming. So we came up on an idea with Khamba and Neeti and Amit the other day, where on 31st of December, we're going to watch Doordarshan TV. Because they had hosted a show, which is a New Year's.
Up to Gaio, right?
Mere ghar mein, yaar. Kya kare? Aur pata nahi kahan se ho raha hai. Like, I don't understand which direction.
No, Suresh was not sure if it was uske ghar mein ho raha hai.
I think all of us are like, is it coming from our side?
Kiska ghar mein ho raha hai?
No, that was normally the sound when Shurubi is beating me up.
Now, the thing is, I don't even know how to mute myself on time. Like, I have to mute it each time he hits it. So, I have to like...
Hey, that's a great
and that guy's watching your stream and he's like, he muted.
Man, this thing of asking people to be silent during shoots, sorry, Saurabh, we've totally sidelined. I can't remember the story now, but you know, as a TV person, somebody, there's a bird somewhere far away in the distance, the sound guy has stopped the whole shoot. Side mein, somebody's doing thak, 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 bhai saab, baad mein kaam karna. Arey, Suresh, just figure out how to mute, sir. He's pretending uske ghar mein koi nahi hai. He's just putting it on a table over there and pretending like he's talking to people and all.
Ah, sorry.
Wow. Okay, so three super chats, and then guys, of course, as we've already discussed, we're going to discuss Great Indian Comedy Show.
Please, I want to hear.
As we've already discussed.
Vamsi Verma says, Jose, you promise Karmasti live every week. This doesn't count, by the way. I don't know if people are recording for me.
I've been touring all the different YouTube channels across YouTube in the past week. We've done Kani's, we've done Manan's this thing, and now Saurabh's. This is all practice for our own lives. So soon, in this coming week, you will see something worse than this.
Yeah, Suresh, I think you and I will have to do our own set side stream. Karna padega. साइड पे करते हैं कानमस्ती 1.0 or something. I don't know.
यार उसको मनन के शो में सब बुला रहा है भाई तो हम लोग सीरियल्स बेटर यू बोन यू एंड मी डू
अगर तुम लोग अकेले मतलब सेपरेट शो करो तो उसका नाम क्या होगा
वी थिंक ऑफ समथिंग ओरिजिनल
समथिंग नॉट येट एडिटेड दैट्स व्हाट इट विल बी कॉल्ड
ओ या दैट्स अ ए सीरियल नॉट अ बैड आईडिया सो वी विल हैव अ वी
आएगा एक दिन
वी जस्ट हैव अ फोटो ऑफ होजे ओवर देयर नॉट विद द गार्लैंड ऑब्वियसली बट जनरली वी विल से दैट वी यू नो We'll become like either Dronacharya and A Club. We have two A Club.
So Saurabh, just to get an understanding of what, you know, the plight that me and Suresh go through it, to an understanding, and you know, is that and of course Jose is, you know, I mean, he is a comedic genius and he's, you know, funny and he's popular in his own right.
Thank you.
Followers. But but the thing is that there's so much of content cut out. If you take that content, there's a good two seasons of unedited content. That's
Two seasons of unedited roadies also. They don't air it.
Oh.
Hey, but Jose, why do you edit stuff out? Why are you infringing on the freedom of expression of Cyril and Jose?
My God.
Like, why? I mean,
not so much.
Jose, before you do it, let me just tell you, before you get into this, look at Saurabh. He puts all his content out like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, correct. It's true.
What is editing is the name of this podcast.
See, after this whole podcast over, he may get a call from Mahesh Bhatt, but he's willing to take the risk.
What?
Oh, the things, you have no idea the things these people say. Cyril is mostly about some penis issue he's having. But Suresh starts talking about stuff like stuff that, you know, I can't air some of that stuff because it might lead to a defamation suit for Suresh, not for me. I have no issues. Mere ko views milega. Must. I'll go viral. Next day, I will go viral. But Suresh's face, he's like, Madhichit, sab bata raha gandu. But Suresh knows things about the industry and things. They just, in general, about life. I mean, he's been around since King Arthur's times.
Yeah, so, yeah, he knows things about King Arthur.
He knows a lot of shit, you know.
Dude, do you remember King Arthur's debut in Bollywood? It was like a really tough debut which he had. Like,
Dharamveer. And he knows the truth in.
Very risky with these two. There's one story in radio also which I can't tell because these days it was not safe to tell these stories. But Suresh, you know, there's something in Konkani, it's called Isa Bonk. Okay. The word is Isa Bonk means chicken's bum. And it's a Goan way of saying that, you know, stuff just comes out of the chicken's bum. So you got to be careful. And Suresh is the Isa Bonk. You never know what he's going to say. Very dangerous. On radio, he was very good though because he knew, you know, All India Radio guidelines. Yeah, with that live stream and all and recording, matlab, you know, three people in the studio is uninhibited. You don't even need to give him.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. The live, the controlling, the lack of democracy that exists in the internet world. A live confession.
I'm just imagining both of you all with jail bars in front of you, guys. Nobody allowed me to say this. I wanted to say something.
I mean, you know, and I unnecessary. Like I've been producing with these guys for I don't know how long, but like I'm still subjected to this hierarchy.
See, whenever they crack good jokes, I keep it on the podcast, and that's why the podcast is so short.
There's none. There's
By the way, it's worth mentioning that Cyril just said it's like South Korea. Just put this out there.
I got the wrong Korea.
It's South Korea.
But he's right. But
somewhere close, I got it wrong.
Maybe you predicted the future.
Yeah, hey, something
there'll be
like
only
that,
one Korea very soon. South Korea, ruled by Malayali.
This is the part that Jose would have edited out in Kaan Masti, I think.
Yeah.
Listen, when you guys do like not... Yeah, when sorry, you do sorry, All no. India Lendok. No. All India Lendok is the show All that I think, yeah. Or, yeah. What is it? Genduk. What is the other one?
Gendul and Lenduk.
Yeah.
Shame on you, Saurabh.
Yeah. How come you've never done a character called Sachin Gendulkar? Like, is that never occurred?
One so, thing.
Manav, please edit that part. Live, out of
no, not about that. I think I'm one of the biggest fans of Sachin. I don't think.
Yeah, obviously.
There's
been
God,
any batsman like him before and after. I mean, the day he
Suresh,
quit, I
Suresh
cried.
Suresh believes that Sachin is personally indebted to him. Because he's such a big fan.
Yes,
I've seen Suresh in the middle of cricket matches getting really upset. And I'm like, is everything okay? Well, we don't know each other that well, but are you being emotional about cricket? I go crazy. This guy would be upset. He wouldn't want to do links. And he'd come on air being upset. And you know, like, and then he'd say things like, what is this? What is going on? I'm like, bro, just relax.
Yeah, we had to calm him down.
He,
get him like
he loves
extra
Sachin.
Coffee.
He really loves Sachin.
Okay, can I tell you the two times that I've once when I fakely upset Suresh Menon, and once when I actually upset Suresh Menon.
I remember the first fakely upset.
Okay, so do you remember the fakely? No, okay, you guys might remember the real one. I'll tell you the fake one. So I'd written a script for Great Indian Comedy Show, which was I think the guy was Sailesh Dabe or something, and I'd written some really weird script. So it was some script about how some seven wonders of the world, and how I'd written a script about how Aishwarya Rai is the eighth wonder of the world, and they're having a meeting about this. This is again 2005, 2006, and she wasn't called Aishwarya Rai. We obviously had to call her Kaishwarya Guy, and then all the references were like Panmohan Bing and
classy.
All that nonsense. Yeah, literally Panmohan that.
Bing.
So just all that stupid nonsense, right? Parendra Nodi is just absolute. Yeah, it's like
that was a Sailesh Dabe trademark, though, right? All the characters were named like this.
No, with that to be because the guidelines had come by the information broadcasting industry that you can't say actual names. So we found a way how to
get around that.
But when you think about it, it's pretty smart. Like right now, they can't even mention them, which is kind of weird. At least like if you're mentioning like Papa Ramdev, right? Then you're allowed there because you're talking about not Papa Ramdev, you're talking about Papa Ramdev. It's a different
entity.
Wow, man.
Papa Ramdev, nice one.
So it makes sense. So I written the script, which I mean, in all honesty, I don't think it was great. And so Sailesh basically said, listen, so I think Suresh, Ranveer and Vinay Pathak were united in that, hey, the script is a piece of shit.
Oh my God.
It's fucking garbage. And then Sailesh Dabe basically told him, he's like, listen, everything's ready to go. This script has to go. So I, as a young writer with my first job, had to go and deal with this. So I remember entering this van, this green room where Suresh Menon is there. And I think Ranveer and Vinay, I don't know who was there. Ranveer, and I tell Vinay. Suresh, I'm like, Suresh, sir, sorry, sir. And Suresh is like having a hunter in his hand. He's like, hey, writer, chuppe and all that. Just like real crazy. And then I said, we have to do this. Sailesh sir has said that he has to do this. Suresh takes the plastic chair and throws it across the room. And he's like, how can you do this to me? And fucking this, that. And I'm like, just standing there, like shitting my pants. And Suresh is like, it's okay. It's a joke. And he walks off. And I'm like, what the fuck is this psycho doing?
Oh my God.
So it's really funny in retrospect. But at that point, I was like, for 5 seconds, I'm like, shit.
Oh, shit. I'm really sorry if I did that.
No, it was funny. It was really funny. But it was very funny.
I would hate myself to be remembered like this ever. So, but I'll tell you the backstory. Why I was so reluctant. Aishwarya Rai and Salman Khan. Okay, so one of the gags that I was made to do that time was where I'm playing Salman of Tirunam, and I go open a house and there's a temple, bro. Temple ke samne Aishwarya ka photo laga hua hai, and I'm doing puja. Right, Salman is still missing, bro. Iske bagar mein jee nahi sakta. Some script was written and it went on air. I got a call, and that time I'm shooting for a film with Salman Khan. I get a call.
Quite brave.
Very gentle call, this is, as they say, you know. And then it said that, hey, listen, how are you doing? I said, fine. Oh, listen, that gag that you did, now please remove it from air. I said, what air? So I said, which gag? No, that bhai.
Wait, who's saying this to you?
I can't take names. So
like a manager type person.
Because nobody knows.
He'll post it on Twitter.
No, he didn't. So
was it Garbaz Khan?
No.
He's already said Salman Khan's name. Ravi bol raha hai, I can't take names. I don't know what the hell.
No, what the guy called me. So, because he was the flunky.
Nothing to do with Salman, of course.
Yeah. So then I said, what's the problem? He said, no, bhai got very upset. He saw this, and how can you make fun? You're working with him. You'd want to work in the industry, no? So I said, so is it a threat? I asked him openly. So he said, no, not a threat. You know, it's just like, just don't do such things, you know. Why? I said, no, but tell me something. If I refuse to do this and I am thrown out of the show, who will pay me money? Are you going to give me a guarantee? I'll give you 10 films a year or 2 films a year. Will you give me the guarantee? So it got into an argument, and I said, do whatever you'll want. Okay. But this is my job, and my job, I'll have to do it. So when the next thing I come to the studio, I'm sure I'm a monument and I'm going to play Salman again. I'm like, see, I remember there was a time when I got a call from the underworld saying that if you don't stop asking for money, we'll come and shoot you. This was
during, he meant the gutters guys,
the guys from the gutters.
What are you talking about?
Yeah. So this is a long time back for a film that I'd done, and those days I was single, so there's no worries. So I said, please come, I'll wait. If you want to shoot in my bum or my chest or my head, you tell me, I'll pose like that and I'll stand. You come and shoot. It'd be so great. Now, such a big producer's man coming in, shooting an unknown actor. It'd be superb. Come and do it. But now, here's the thing. If somebody's threatened you, now you've got to think of child, wife, family, father who's alone now. All those things running my mind. Damn it. How can you face this? And this was around about the third threat that I had gotten at that time. From another producer whose film that we had dissed in that Ratan GM bus. Wow, Baba.
What are you
film,
saying?
Man.
You used to get threats early, and all just for making fun
early
of
90s.
Films,
So those
early
days,
90s. Holy shit.
This is early 2000s.
2000s. Yeah.
Thank you.
Before the radio scene happened.
So then I'm wondering, for my bravado, I don't want to put my family in risk. So I started becoming slightly more careful when scripts started coming to me, you know. Slightly when people started saying that, are dharega ne to, because once you are caught, na, like I remember Kiku did that whole thing about that guy in one show.
Ram Rahim.
One show for a guy called Vikas Kalantri, who was a producer of that show. Once Kiku was arrested, that guy didn't even pick up phones. Why would you risk yourself for doing this? But if I was alone, I would have taken panga like this. Even now, today, I'm saying, if I get
Yo,
to be
we've,
alone,
we've talked about
I will
this.
Be,
people,
I'll be more open about everything possible. There's nothing to be worried, nothing to worry about. Because what these guys do, they don't come and hit you per se. They come and hit your family, and that's what you have to be very careful. You have to protect your family, man. The rest of the things follow later.
But Suresh, I want to take this opportunity to apologize for my mom calling up that time and having this chat. I told her that was not cool, mom. You should have released this.
So, Saurabh, just to clear, God, I'm very sorry if I came across like a boor, man. Would hate.
No, dude, that was really funny. What are you talking about? That was I still remember it as a hilarious moment. I was playing it up for the comedy, but it was a really funny moment because I remember that. You know what I remember is that, like, even though it was a comedic bit, Suresh in his head, I could sense him calculating whether this chair is going to break or no. Right? So,
because he gets.
When was that time? It was completely deserved. That time you were just being dicks.
When was it?
But it was all Cyril's idea.
Oh God! So.
Oh shit! You don't know this story, or what?
No.
Of course, he knows the story.
Hey, 1 second.
You didn't.
When was this?
इसको याद नहीं है. याद नहीं है उसको.
ये कभी हुआ था? Red FM में था तभी.
जब Bembo's चालू था उस टाइम पे. Does anyone remember Bembo's?
Bembo's, best burgers in town.
Wow,
wasn't Jose with us there? Oh no.
He was. I used to come out of the house sparingly. Those were the days.
So the Twitter blue tick that I got also has got a story. So one day I get a call on my birthday, some 2, 3, 4 years back, I think. And one lady is talking to me saying that I'm calling from Twitter and we want to give you a blue tick.
Firstly, that was us, na?
That was you all only idiots. So I said, hey, listen, no, this is like I'm sure Ozzy and Cyril, somebody has put, then again that call comes and keeps on coming. Sir, we need verification. We are not joking about it. So I called up Ozzy. Ozzy, come on, yeah. So he said, no, really? Oh, bro, damn good. So it's not me. So, you know, bro, I don't wake up so early. And all. I said, okay, damn it. This could be a truth. Then in the end, it turned out to be one guy was impersonating a woman. We can't mention that guy's name nowadays. So, and it turned, then I got so angry and upset about this whole prank. I really got...
No, then
I felt, why do this to an old man, you know? Who is not even a part of the internet community? Why they're making fun of me and all this stuff? Then later on, everything.
Were the days when people really wanted that blue ticket. It was just starting out and stuff.
But Jose,
and I remember by some miracle, my account got verified. So back in the day, if you posted stuff that showed that it was coming from your account and pictures of you and like. Relevant information, after a point there was an automated kind of like system that would go out. It send you a link, you answer a few questions, and then they probably reviewed it, and then you get a blue tick. But many people thought that it was because, you know, like some VIP system, or you have to be celebrity or something, and I let that stereotype perpetuate because I wanted to feel cool. But many people wanted to know ki kaisa ho gaya, are mere ko bhi chahiye and all. So I remember before Suresh was even going crazy about it, Suresh, I didn't really care that much. But then when they started asking him ki, would you like to be verified, then he was like, yeah, of course. But but I remember KRK wanted to be verified.
Oh God.
And I think this had happened a little after the MTV thing. I can't even remember. All the past is all one big souffle now. But KRK wanted to be verified, and he messaged me, sent me a message. Somehow he got my cell number. God damn it. He sent me a message saying, I want to be verified, please. Jose bhai, thoda help kar lena. Now, I think he might have posted this on Twitter a couple of times also, and on whatever other social media. So you know how evil the internet is, right? So people started sending him like these fake links and all, trying to hack his phone or something. So, and I mean, I guess everybody's, it's a smart way to go. You know, somebody wants to be verified. I mean, any hacker with half a brain would, or sorry, what's that? A scammer with half a brain would want to do that. So people send him links and he clicked it also. So uska account mein kuch gadbad ho gaya, and I think somebody managed to go through his stuff and all. He accused me of hacking his phone. Yeah.
Publicly that too.
What? Luckily, those days the media was not, and I was a nobody, thankfully. I still am. So it didn't become a big deal or anything. But here, it was almost like, you know, like when somebody comes to the media and says, "Isne mere saath aisa aisa kiya," all, he accused me of hacking his phone. And I was like, what? Why?
Also, there was a perception. Also, there was a perception in the community that time that Jose was actually Twitter. So people mentioned Twitter, it was like Jose is he's a CEO or MD on Twitter. It's so that's why. Because I think you were one of the
few. You felt people, that because you wanted to be verified.
I think the only person was above a million plus followers without paying for it.
Yeah.
I mean, that's debatable.
No, I completely like that believe that. Years. I completely believe that Jose was radio, Mr. Radio. I completely believe that Jose is Mr. Internet.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. That's very kind.
Yeah.
Nobody asked.
Payment baad mein de.
What is the future now, Jose? Since you predicted these two things, which is radio and internet, what is the next thing, Jose? Tell us today and we'll mark this and have this conversation 14 years later.
Yeah. So I'm not sure, but I feel like there's going to be something that will force us to all be in our homes. And we'll have to like sort of live stream and wash our hands and stuff. And I think we're going to, this is a coming future. There might be a pandemic. It seems like it. I don't know. But the future is that we'll have to go back to no internet and no nothing, just gardening and, you know, carpentry and stuff.
Okay, let's talk about friendship.
Issue right now. Let's
talk about friendship.
Let's talk about friendship, guys. See, this is my segues that I have. Is that
nice? I like it.
Great
sharp
conversation.
Let's talk about friendship.
Yeah. Like, well said, Jose. Let's move on now.
Okay, by the way, let's take some more super chats. People are really excited. Anirudh Agnihotri says, this has become a Kanmasti episode. Thanks for working this out. Hey, appreciate it, man. Hiren S, you have been a fan of Kanmasti since Jose came on AIB's podcast very early on. You came on AIB's podcast?
Yes.
Wow.
Oh, okay. It was a long time ago when AI was still around.
Eye white balance is off.
Sorry about that. Damn it, I should try some fancy stuff like you guys.
I think I did one of their podcasts. Yeah.
By the way, John Abraham is here. John Abraham is in the comments.
Oh, wow.
And he's real John Abraham.
Yeah, must be.
Of course, obviously. John Abraham has a YouTube channel where he uploads videos of his acting reels, which is different kinds of makeup.
Hi, John.
Hi, John. Wow.
Don't do Karmasti feelings, feedback or anything. Just do this only. Okay. That's what we'll do. Oh, but by the way, this was 1 hour back. So we've already done it.
That guy's gone to sleep and he's like, they're not reading all my chats.
Hey, this is an interesting question. Yeah, Karthik Sharma says, loved the comedy trio of Sajid Khan and Suresh Menon, who played multiple characters. And a third guy who played Dilip Kumar, occasionally screaming, "Hey, bhai." Who's the third guy?
Yeah. So there was this guy called Abid was, I mean, he believed he was Dilip Kumar, and you know, he believed that he's one of the he is the finest actors. And once I remember we were shooting for a movie, we were in Dubai, Diwani Ve Pagal. He first time he's meeting Sunil Shetty. Imagine the first time in your life you're meeting an actor. Okay, so he goes up to that guy and says, Sunil, calls him Sunil. Okay, ye jo tumne tumhari wajah se main aaj hero nahi hun. So Sunil Shetty got shocked and he said, maine kya kiya? He says, jis din tumhara wo Balwan picture release hua, baniyan pehenkar tum body bata rahe the, usi din meri bhi ek film release hui thi. Sab log tumhare nangapan ko dekhne hai, mujhe dekhne nahi aaya.
My God.
And he walked away. He was that pissed. And Anna is like, who's this guy? I said, oh, sorry. No, he's in that sort of mood. But that guy, Sajid and me have laughed on his face. We have thrown water on his face. We have done weird things to him. Makeup man has jumped in between the shots to beat him up. But he would never leave Dilip Kumar's accent. So whatever Dilip Kumar I imitated on radio, wherever I did, was only imitating Abid.
I like there was a comment after he would never leave Dilip Kumar's accent. He would not leave the show.
Like he's getting dramatized and he's getting attacked, but he's still fine.
There was a time in, we were doing this thing on, what do you call, extra fittings. Based on extra in Mandira Bedi. So our makeup man in between the running shot, he has jumped on Dilip Kumar, on Abid, and both of them have fallen down from the chair, okay? And there's a moment when I'm looking and Sajid is still Mandira Bedi, and I look down and Abid is down on the floor and he has gone. And I said, Abid, I said, Pani leke ho. And he got up. And everyone said, break lena hai. Well, nah, koi break nahi ho gaya. Ye madrasi aur ye jo aurat hai na yahan par, he continued. He lambasted her in the shot for what had happened during the shot, but without leaving character, without leaving that zone, without taking anybody's names. He was that amazing, absolutely amazing, Abid.
But one second, is he plays that character throughout his life or what?
So even if you met him normally in life, he would probably hear him, "Bhai, kaise ho?"
Dude, this is such a great sketch idea, man. It's just a guy who is like just playing this one old, and throughout the day he's just playing this character. And people are like, "Dude, you have a problem." And he's like, "Nahi, mere to koi problem hai."
I had a film idea for Suresh where, did you ever see that film where it's a very old English film? I can't remember. I don't know if it was Meg Ryan or something, but the man and the woman who are in love with each other, they swap bodies.
Oh, switch. What a brilliant idea you had. Yeah.
Their spirits swap or something. So anyway, the idea was for Suresh, okay. This is the plot line for the film, okay. Suresh is a guy who does an Amitabh Bachchan voice. He's an Amitabh Bachchan impersonator. And one day, he's interviewing the real Amitabh Bachchan. They shake hands and they swap bodies. So now Amitabh Bachchan is living as this guy who does an Amitabh Bachchan voiceovers. And the voiceover guy is now getting to live the real Amitabh Bachchan.
What a life that would be.
But then nobody bought my script. I don't know what happened.
Seriously? Suresh, you can still do this. Yeah, like just like have a French beard and just show up at like when he was at Leelavati. You could have just like snuck his body.
Suresh, you can play both characters.
Dude, imagine Suresh on KBC interviewing himself. He's like,
but the fact of the matter is, if we go to Amitabh Bachchan with the script and also sign the signing amount that he charges, he would not say no. That's what I like about him. He would never say
I'm sure
no.
It would intrigue him as a script. It's as Bachchan, sir, if you're watching this, I know you want Saurabh stuff.
That too, apart from money, that too.
He didn't write that movie, dude. He's Bachchan did that movie, right? Where he there was a guy who's his voiceover artist and some shit happens. Dude, this is an
But that was more serious with that
Shamitabh. Yeah. Which is roughly the same idea, except like not funny.
Son of a gun.
Damn it. They stole it from your mind, man.
Without me telling them even.
Fucking mind plagiarism. Okay, Yash N says, hey, I'm not a paid fan of Jose because he hasn't paid me for my last week's comments. Jokes apart, the super chat has a word limit. I'm a big fan of Suresh and Cyril. Oh, see, this is kindness.
How nice. This is kindness.
This is sweet. Yeah, this is sweet at the end of it.
Like, that's my other account, guys. Yeah. I don't want them to feel bad. So.
Yes, he was just, I saw you typing.
He was messing.
But it is a circle, right? That's what we were doing when Jose was just on his way for popularity. I would like sit down and make multiple accounts and chat with Jose, you know, and
it's all an illusion.
It's all illusion. No one has real, no one's following anyone out here. It's just us chatting with each other and different names.
Hey, Cyril, so how come you never like, you've always been like on the periphery of sort of plunging into like this kind of stuff, which is like, but you've never ever committed to it properly. Is it intentional or is it that something
he's
else?
Running
Let's
businesses
get psychological,
now.
Guys.
I mean, you know, I looked at it and for everyone who probably doesn't know too much about me, which is mostly everybody, I've always been on the back end of working with people like Saurabh and Jose and Suresh and stuff like that. Like I preferred it. So I think between Saurabh and, you know, especially Jose, who pushed me into doing content, I think there was that point in my life where I was like, do I want to give up, you know, being producer and, you know, and business person and you know, make this full time, because it is what you all do means it's a full time thing, right? It's a lot of energy and a lot of focus. You can't do both. At least at that time, you couldn't do both. You had to be good at one thing for sure. And then I realized being a producer and a business person is a far more money and far more, you know, success. So I was like, you know, I'll leave it to the old people to do this
kind
of thing.
Wow.
Okay,
wow. Amir log.
I know Saurabh tried a lot in Channel V to push me through and you know, let's do content and let's do stuff like that. I think this, I felt like I was not fully cut out for it. Like, you know, it seemed like
the funny
Cyril, riding
quite funny.
And being a producer, I gave, I think, all of y'all individually in different, like a lot of slack for stuff that I don't think it's funny. We shouldn't do it. So to put yourself out there to be judged was a lot of weight for me. Like, I'll be like, now they'll have a chance to say, Cyril, you're not funny, which is true.
This is some real talk going on here.
Yeah. So I think it's that's what feelings. It was. I did enjoy Vine though. I thought Vine was probably the best thing that happened, and Vine really charted.
For a second, I was like, why are we talking about alcohol? Then I realized you're talking about Vine.
That's if anything.
But Cyril used to come on air along with Jose and me as Jagdish Bhai. I'm telling you some of the things that he has said on the show are so funny. You know, sometimes there are times when I used to drive back home from Nariman Point on my own.
Cyril is the original Kaniz.
Yeah.
I'll tell you a story about that, Ian.
About Kaniz? No, we are not interested.
Yeah.
So,
wow.
We have not forgiven her. So,
oh my God.
Forgiven her?
Oh, that's a Twitter battle, the right wing versus left wing. That's a long story. Okay. So,
I like how Saurabh is like, that's my no.
Transition. And now we move to something.
I don't even know what happened. Yeah.
Question, where was I? I forgot. See,
you're talking about Jagdish Bhai.
Jagdish Bhai. So, the thing, we used to talk, it was so funny. And, you know, Jose used to just play along saying that, hey, listen, tell us Jagdish Bhai's advice for the day. So one day he said, and Cyril's Hindi, those days were like even worse than what it is now. So he went on saying, ek hai, wo hai, जो नहीं है वो नहीं जाओ.
So then, to give you context,
yeah. And then Jose to pick out what he actually meant. So it was so funny.
Yeah. To give you context, it's exactly what I think. Jose basically had absolutely this, like, he had no work and he just put everyone on the spot. And that was what it was, right? He put Suresh on the spot and I was not even supposed to be on it. I was producing that show. Yeah. So he'd be like, and we have Jagdish. I'm like, no, you mother, fuck off. No. And then the mic is on. And so now I can't even have dead air. The responsibility and it's his of show the because he's the producer. Yeah. So I'm like, ha, bolie. So he's like, say something about the rains. I'm like, jab barish aate hai. And they're like, wow, wow, jab barish aate hai, sab log gilla hota hai. And
damn it, now Hindi has become better, yeah.
Now it's become a little better, but I'll say and respect to how things are, what we did. I do still think that, and I strongly believe that Kaniz has done a far more fantastic job of it. I spoke to her. I was the original Hindi person.
No one's comparing it. It's okay. She's legendary. That was a decade ago. Yeah. It's all right.
Seriously, yeah, guys.
It's all right. You guys are friends even. It's not a big issue. You'll know each other.
Someone give me some work, please.
This is terrible. Itihas mein maaf nahi kiya.
Who's Itihas? Do I know?
Itihas.
Yeah. But dude, Cyril and me have gone on these like solo drinking trips. Okay, we went to Nasik ages back in Sula Vineyards. So the plan was that we planned to take everybody along with us. I think Jose, we'd asked you also, and Suresh.
The number of times they're like, we're going to Pune, we're going to Sula, and I'm like, thank you, bro. I mean, so Cyril, we know each other, but we don't know each other that well.
Yeah. So we went to Sula Vineyards and we got really drunk, and then we were hopping across mountains and kissing frogs. At least I was doing that. And then there was we were like, hey, let's go. We had a driver and all, okay, just to assure you that we weren't driving drunk. We showed up at this place where it is called Marigold, which is apparently the only nightclub in Nasik. And Marrygold, not like, I don't know if it is intentional or unintentional, the misspelling. But this is like all crazy music happening. So we're trying to enter inside and the guy's like, sorry, a couple's only. So Cyril, me, I'm like, yeah, but we are a couple. And he let us in and we're like, shit, this worked. The strategy has worked.
Wow. So progressive of them. That's amazing.
So we enter inside and we're like, yeah, fuck, I can't believe this tactic worked. And we're like fucking dancing and going crazy for 5 minutes. And then the music stops because he allowed us in because they were shutting the place down. But we were determined to continue. So we are pretending music is still on and dancing there till the point this guy like, sir, ho gaya. We're like, but we are a couple. He's like, fuck off, dude.
He's like, mere ko pata tha, apne ko log chahiye tha andar.
Yeah. It was a good trip. We thought we trekked up like this big mountain and all. And then of course, once he sobered up, it was like a, you know, like Pali Hill, like on this like bump or something like that.
Someone left some mud on the road.
Yeah. But you know, I do, before you do transition, Saurabh, I just want to take this moment and just say that, you know, just mention interesting points of how I met each one of y'all and how that transitioned into a friendship. Like for Saurabh, now by Saurabh, you know, we met in Channelview, but my respect for Saurabh as this is a guy you're going to have, you know, decline. As part of your life circle, not decline, part of your life circle, is this moment. So Saurabh one day, all right, he's like, hey, will you come with me? And this was when Saurabh had hair, okay, or reminiscence of hair at that time. So he's saying, can you come with me? And I'm like, where are we going? He's saying, we're going to Dr. Can I mention his name?
Yeah, go for it.
Okay, we're going to Dr. Batra. So I was like, and Dr. Batra was like crazy at that time. He was super big, right? He was just advertising massively in the early 2000s. And I said, oh shit, okay, what are we going there? He's like, I'm going there to get my refund. I'm like, hold on a sec. You have managed to convince Dr. Batra to refund money back to you because he did
this
not.
This is the most ridiculous story I've ever
heard. I was like, and I went with him because I didn't believe him. I thought he was just scamming me. And I went and we gave him a check. Okay, Dr. Batra refunded money back to Saurabh. And I'm like, dude, legend that you got it back.
So I remember, do you know what the story was? So back then what had happened was that they said that we'll charge, and again, listen, if it works for somebody, I'm not shitting on that, but it didn't work for me. They charged 9,000 bucks for a year and I'd done it for about 6 months or something like that. And I was like, there's no difference. I'm still losing hair. And the guy was showing me a whiteboard, and he was like, you know, the rate of the hair that was supposed to go has been reduced and some stuff like that. And I'm like, just give me my money back. And he's like, we can't give like your full money back. And he's like, we'll give you some amount. I'm like, give whatever. Because I was not earning much anyway. So wow. I'm like, give me 3,000 bucks. It's very exciting. So yeah.
Oh my God. Wow. What a crazy story.
That was a hair-raising story.
Hair-raising.
You know, what Saurabh, like in Cyril's style, what Saurabh left out is that the man on the board had written on the board, when did you get this on your head? Sorry, some juvenile. See, this is what happens. You forget it on a live stream. It's a big platform, and you say something like that.
Yeah, that's but these are turning points in friendships. Like, you know, when I met Jose for the first time.
Yeah.
Apparently, all my stories seem to start like this. So we were both interviewing for Red FM at that time. And we had gone to meet our programming, then soon to be programming head. So I had finished my meeting and I was told to hang back for a bit. And Jose walks in. Now, Jose and I kind of didn't know each other. I was kind of maybe infamous in school. So
I knew Cyril was because he was very famous in school. Finish your story. I'll tell you what you were doing in school.
Jose, now I'm sitting out there and Jose walks in wearing a kurta. Okay, this is probably the only time he's ever worn a kurta in his life, probably.
He's to wear a lot of kurta.
And I'm like, hey, you know, I say hi to him because, you know, excited, red radio, that excitment as a kid, you're so I'm full like glee. I say hi to him. He turns around and he gives me the most cold, hey, attitude response. Whoa. And then this ignores me and walks away.
I do not recall this, but I'll tell you, I have a sense of
and
why
I respect
it might
him since then.
Can I tell you, by the way, that Cyril thinks that everybody responds to him coldly when they meet him. I think like his response is like, where it's like, Cyril, oh my God. Yeah.
He wants to kiss or something. Like,
what about me, Cyril?
But Suresh, let me tell you, Suresh was the opposite of that. When I met Suresh for the first time, of course, he was supposed to be a big star in television. And, you know, that's the first time I met him was the radio, right? And he's a big TV
guy. You said you all met on a naked nude beach?
That was later. And that was Jew Beach. And we didn't know it was not supposed to be naked. But
somebody was like, why is there a gola on our penis? It's like Kala Katta.
They're like, guys, why are you holding the Kala Katta down there? point was that, so I met Suresh, and Suresh was this enthusiastic guy, right? He was very sweet. And he'd always do this thing, like, I think I was with somebody, we do this where if we see someone who looks good or pretty, you pretend to drool. And I was like, is this guy being funny or is he being creepy? I'm not sure which one it is because I was like, very confused. But I said, he seems like he has a loving demeanor, right? And I think we got along fun. Because he was very light compared to some of the other personalities that we had, who were very serious, intense guys on radio. So yeah, so that was my turning points with, I think, the three of you all.
So the reason I might have been cold to Cyril was because in school, Cyril was this guy that everyone was afraid of because he was a bit of a psychopath.
Really?
He'd go around like beating up people, and he was known to be one of those guys who get into fights and all. So I was like, oh shit, this guy's working with me.
I will have to work.
Oh God.
Bajao.
And he had this menacing, I mean, look at it. He had this menacing look like, fucking, I'm going to kill you. And bro, in school, I'm still pretty small in that sense. But in school, I was one of those kids who would, you know, tell the guy a joke to try and distract him and then run away before he'd beat me up. So yeah, that kind of thing.
Oh man.
But I heard Cyril used to get away with a lot because there was some relative who was some up top person or something. Wasn't that the story?
No, he didn't get away with a lot, but the principal was related to him.
Oh, in the school? Yeah. I'll be open about it. Yes, we have had past tense, future tense, who knows? The right set of people in the right set of places. That was about it. But let me tell you.
What a way to say it.
Wow, dude. Wow, seriously, man.
Hey, that's why I apologize to Suresh for my mother calling him in the early 2000s. How did that? But no, nothing like that.
No, the principal was related to Cyril, and that's why the principal would always walk around the school like this.
Yeah.
Dude, but when you meet Cyril, right? So say Cyril is like 6'2". What are you? 6'2".
Six and a half.
7'5", whatever.
When I stand straight.
Yeah, and then you meet his brothers,
stand
right?
On his toes.
And his brothers are like, they ate him. The first one looks like he will eat him. And the second one is like, he ate both the two brothers and then had this bulk.
His brothers are taller than him. That's so freaky.
I've never seen this, Cyril.
Yeah. I mean, now they're a shadow of what
they don't like to be
Cyril, do you want to say the story about how Noel, you and me went to see Luke and Eli?
No, please, Christopher, you and Diego.
Was it Christopher?
Yeah.
Which one was Noel? Oh, yeah, it was Christopher. So Christopher is Luke, big fucking 6'5" guy, and he's like burly and he looks dangerous, right? And we went to see Luke and Eli in concert at Hard Rock Cafe.
Noel. That's Noel.
So Luke and he's singing, right? Because they have this, I think, black... what is it? Black, what the fuck was the name of the
Black
band?
Black Eyed Peas.
No, he
had a band. He used to sing in a band. Some black...
They were doing...
Deep Purple covers.
Mm. And so Luke and he's on stage, right? He's like, yeah. Blah, blah, blah. And Noel is like, this fucker doesn't know how to sing, man. And he's like right under his face. Like, Noel, relax, dude.
Yeah.
And then Luke and he's throwing t-shirts. And Noel is tall, right? He's literally throwing people out of the t-shirt. And saying, you suck, man, Luke Kenny. And he's like, relax with Noel. Just give me the shirt.
Yeah. And Luke, I think, was my like programming head at that time. So let me give you a heads up. The reason why I don't go out with my brothers, I love them, and this is what I should tell Saurabh in, is my brothers, and Noel was not like he was drinking or high. This is who he is. I mean, that's how my brothers are. They're very straight. So I remember one time you had this bar even. Okay, it's a small bar, Toto's. Okay, you literally, like 10 people are sitting in this area. And I remember one of our common friends, Anu, was there. And a guy was just checking her out, you know. And she just happened to mention, oh, this guy's just staring at me. Now, if I am Noel, this other guy is this Mike. Okay, he's literally this close to the next table. Noel turns to him and says, this bullshit is looking at you. And I'm like, oh, God. It literally, that's who Noel was at the end of it. And Saurabh loved tagging along in these scenarios, especially with my brothers, and aggravating
things
them.
Things would get heated.
Yeah, he'd put more fire into them. Like, I remember we went to this one time where I think one of those theme parks where you test your strength. Yeah, and the hammer. And then he's telling my brother, Chris, like, I don't know, I think you're, you know, you're damn weak and all. And Chris is like, bloody four times both our sizes, and I think Chris is literally breaking the machine. Like, I think the machine was into pieces. And I'm like, I need to keep Saurabh away from my family. But yeah, that's what I grew up with.
Wow, man. Hey, I never met him.
Who? Huh? Yeah.
I never met Cyril's brothers.
They'll be down soon. Yeah, you get to meet them. They're not worth it.
Shut up, man. Okay.
Okay, somebody's saying, oh, Rish, this is a question. Okay. There's a lot more. This thing. Cyril is the most underrated, say Shantanu Parab. He should go for stand-up. There you go, man. That's a high compliment, I guess.
Yeah. I mean, depending on who he is as a character. If he's drunk, then I'll have to just not like take this serious.
Pranab Bhatt, thanks. He's saying happy to this. Adhvut Pawar says thanks again. T. Omi, Virat Kohli is going to be a dad soon. Okay.
Breaking news on your channel.
मैंने कुछ नहीं किया.
Hey, okay. This is a question for Suresh. Suresh, I'm sure you've answered this question, which is that Suresh, sir, what's your take on stereotyping gay characters in the Indian cinema, given that you played a few times?
Oh God.
You've answered this question before, no?
Yeah. So many times.
We've discussed this also.
Now it's a non-issue because nobody, everyone, like I don't get these roles anymore. So people who are actually gay, they get those roles. So. That's it. So it's become simpler now for people. People have come out in the open. And at that time when we were doing these roles, it was more of a caricature for sure. But there were people who I consciously imitated because I was very good at imitating people. So I could imitate actual people who behaved like that. But now it's a no issue, a non-issue. No, I don't think it's that important or relevant anymore. It's a role is a role is a role. You do whatever you can. So there's no caricature. Nobody does these caricatures anymore.
Also, I think like at all ages, right? There was a point where some things were acceptable and whatever. And then things like us cross-dressing in Channel V is probably something that we wouldn't do right now. It was just, actually, I still would. Just because it's funny.
Even nice. I would.
Wearing
I would,
a skirt is really nice.
Yeah, it's damn liberating,
I would,
dude.
I would do it on
Kapil Sharma. Do you go through your old stuff and think, man, I shouldn't have, oh, that was not funny. Or do you feel like, oh man, I wish I had never done that?
Sorry. I go through my new stuff and think that. I'm like, this is bullshit. Why are you doing this? That's why I started doing a live stream.
For a couple of months.
that's why I'm doing a live stream. I'm like, hey, I have an alternative career right here.
I think what that guy's question was about, Suresh, was more about how you feel now. I mean, in retrospect, we've had this conversation and
yeah.
I mean, we've all had to do so many things that we didn't want to do. I mean, bro, we are now in this age of internet where, you know, people pull out stuff that you did in your personal. I kind of feel a bit lucky that some of the stuff we did was in that era where it was not being archived to the internet. There's a lot of stuff that we did, all of us, a lot of stuff that we did that didn't get archived to the internet, which is not that great. And some of that stuff, I'm like, oh my God, why? Oh shit, kya majboori, okay, theek hai, kar diya. You know, that kind of stuff. So, yeah. So, some of the first episodes of Kaan Masti, I'm listening to it. I'm like, man, sure. We have looked, what the fuck were we doing? Yeah. And the good news is it was 8 years ago. So then that much of time has passed. And
nothing has matured or changed. Yeah.
And yeah.
Dude, I started a new channel, which has got snippets from this show. And in that I had uploaded stand-up from like 8 years back. Right. And I was like, hey, listen, so we need to get that to start monetizing. So that those clips back then had views. So I was just telling Manav, I'm like, hey, let's just put them up so that we get the monetization. He's like, no, listen, that's one Vice video away from ending your career. This makes sense. Because a lot of the shit, and it's not incredibly insane, but it's just, it was the context. Dude, there are people who hate Friends, right? Because they're like, yeah. Friends is a bad show now because of relations between whatever. I don't even know what the argument is.
Yeah, they put a lot of references that were inappropriate to today's world and stuff like that. I mean, you're always going to find fault in everything, right? I mean, that's the evolution of content and evolution of the way people live their life at the end of it. There is no perfect way, but...
To be very honest, we've all done some trashy stuff. I mean, now also, but when we were younger... Please, do you want me to share my screen again?
No, but one second. I always feel that, you know, what was relevant that time is not relevant today. So whatever we did now, work at whatever at that time, it does kind of work now. That's about it. So I think whatever stuff people
I disagree with that. One minute, Goswami.
I am objective enough. Once upon a time, I used to love papayas. Now, I like
yeah.
That's good. Saurabh speaks since he's making the most sense.
Yeah. Every story should start with, I love papayas.
Yeah.
Hey, have you guys ever done a news debate when you're... Suresh, we discussed this last time. You've done something.
Yeah.
Impersonated Arnab, sitting next to Arnab.
Sitting next to Arnab live.
Twice
what are you talking about? Channel.
Yeah.
It was an Arnab show.
So this was a time when something had happened on the parliament where Jaya Bachchan said that, you know, RJ should be stopped from imitating politicians. It's not right. So that became a big topic for Arnab in the night. So I get a call from him and then suddenly I'm sitting next to him. Okay. And totally unprepared. Suddenly. Looking like a, yeah, because, I thought jacket, kuch to nothing. I look like one word cap ulta karke aisa baitha, and I'm wondering, don't worry. Be honest about it. Go for it, Suresh. Don't worry about anything. Let's show it to them. This is not the way to try and control people. And then he started off. And then, as usual, he didn't give any chance. I tried to butt in. So, once I went out doing that. And suddenly, people have imitated me also. And I'm not afraid. Today, I got Suresh Menon with me, who imitates me quite often. So, let's take it over to him. So, I began by saying, Arnab, let me speak, sir. Let me speak. The nation needs to know. Hats off to that guy. He actually... laughed, you know, and that was when he was at Times Now. So that was the good fun, man. So
the old
I will never forget this in between. I'll never forget this in between the news ka thing, you know how fast he works. So we feel that he doesn't get facts and all that stuff. He's got a team who's so good. So in between some Sanjay Jha of Congress had said something and he said, I remember this is not the way people should encourage such people. And what is the harm in creative people coming and doing something? It's for entertainment. So and everybody is nodding. Meanwhile, suddenly in front of the table, I see one hand coming up with a small chit. And I saw it. And the chit suddenly, Arnab is still there. Yes. And then he pulls it next to him like that. And you can see, please go on, Mr. Sanjay. Now, let me ask you one question. In 2013, May so-and-so date. Oh, God. He had got information when Sanjay Jha had actually pulled up somebody for imitating Manmohan Singh. Oh, baap re.
Wow. Well done.
Who handed him the chip, though? One of the producers.
So you just hand him. So beautiful. Yeah. One hand just comes up the table like this. Like, now we can see.
And he pats him a little bit as it goes back down.
Just, like,
It's like a glass. I need some water or not.
I think we should start a news channel and do that. You know, news the whole day. And we get to talk the whole day. We get paid also. And that's it.
Yeah. Jose is thinking right now.
What are all trying to do here?
Yeah. Jose is thinking.
But we are not discussing news.
That
we can discuss news.
Yeah. That Arnav got Suresh on the panel. It could have gone even worse. Suresh has said something more controversial. Arnav like, no, hold on a second.
All kittens should be murdered. What the fuck, Arnav? Kittens are bastards of the highest order. I hate cats, dogs also.
And then Suresh is like, well, life? Okay. Sorry, I didn't mean to say that.
Dude, I love that guy who pops up though, man. I've done the debate, like multiple debates, and I don't think in any other of the, so they do this regularly at news debates, but the guy at Times Now / Republic was the most subtle about it. And he would just come and the seamlessness of it, right? Because what Arnav would do was he would be like this thing and then just straight away register the information and go ahead. Yeah. One of my favorite moments that I tried to recapture, which never happened, was that Vinod Kambli was on the same panel as me, right? So I had unfortunately shaved my beard, I think, that time. And so, I had a French beard and he had shaved. So we didn't look alike. So I was like, I was seeing the TV screen in front of me. And there was a point when both of us popped up at the same time, right? And Vinod Kambli was like this. I was like, I was trying to do the same action just so I could screenshot it for Instagram. And I see the producer looking at me and saying, switch, and then switch to me. I'm like, you bastard, this is the one opportunity I had. But yeah. Rohan, Jose, you've never done a news debate or been called, or what is your scene?
Yeah, he was on a news channel recently.
No, I've done a couple like over Skype and stuff, but I find them quite pointless, to be honest.
Yeah, actually quite pointless. It's just, if it's an, like, I got called for the nepotism brigade debate and all that stuff. Yeah. I didn't go on because it's pointless. Yeah. You know, they are,
I don't know about debates. I think what we need is pure investigative journalism. Plus.
Correct. Yeah. That's it. Those good old days of...
It's now more entertainment, right? That's what it is. It's become entertainment.
It's only entertainment.
Yeah. Sensationalizing.
Yeah.
I normally get calls for when my subscription runs out. That's as close as I get to news channels.
Dude, my wife had such an interesting point where she's like, you know, the biggest problem right now is that because there's no TV shows being produced and there's no sports, the only source of all drama right now is the news.
Oh no.
That's such a great point, dude, because that's literally the reason point. Why everybody's gravitating towards it, because there's no... And like, irrespective of where you stand on the Sushant Singh Rajput issue, I think like after a point, I'm like, I think Bollywood really needs to get back to work. They just need have a distraction to start working, because you know what my favorite thing, I think we discussed this the last time, is random people who you know have either attitude problems or not enough talent are like, I didn't get through because of nepotism. And I'm like, I think it's because you're not good. It's a possibility.
That possibility, nobody wants to look
no
at.
No one wants to discuss that publicly, yeah. But I think you're right, and your wife's bang on right about it. I think news channels are just one shy of now having cold openings. Like, you know, you'll have a scene, Arnav's walking in slow motion, there's some planes flying.
Oh yeah, nice.
It's going to happen. Eventually, it's going to happen. It'll become a movie. So it'll be like a blockbuster one-hour episode.
Hey, let's do it, nah? Before he does it, let's do it.
it's literally going to be that, I think, because...
And then he comes on the screen and he looks like this and Pitaji. And he says,
and
Pitaji, that's all.
Yeah, Suresh, you will have a big part because they will do like live impersonations of like these cases. So you'll be like playing these characters live.
Oh,
it cuts
wow.
back to all of these things. Yeah, so I'm just saying, you know, put the idea out there.
We can do this for the next Karmasti episode, guys. Now, Suresh, see, the big advantage of having no hair is the wigs are easier.
Yeah, very much easier.
Yeah,
superb.
I realize that too, even though I don't wear wigs that often, but I realize that it's like...
I'm getting into business where I'm getting this wigs stitched into a cap. So instead of wearing a hat, you just wear this and you can just walk. So it's got hair. So today I want to be a hippie, so I'll have long hair. Today I want to look like like a banker, so I'll have short hair. So I'm going to do something like that. So everybody has got their own. People are losing hair. Why unnecessarily go through all that, you know, process of implanting hair, going for medication, going and sticking something on your scalp? Just wear this as a cap and get out. That's it. Enjoy the day. I think it's a great business.
Enjoy the day. Now that we're talking about hair, you know who's come for my show twice? I do these shows at NCPA, right? And twice for my show, no, three times actually for my show, Dr. Batra has been in the audience.
Wow.
And each time I've forgotten, like, I he's very nice and very sweet man, right? And his Instagram is also fun, where he's just in a park singing, and it's like, he's a very sweet man.
Oh.
So each time I've forgotten to do this refund bit. And every time in my head, I'm like, dude, he's here, just do it. And I forget, I'm like, fuck.
I'm going to thank Dr. Batra and the audience for the 6,000 rupees I got back.
It'll just be great, and thank you to Dr. Batra, who's done a lot for my hair. That's it.
Awesome, guys. Thank you so much. We've almost hit the 2-hour mark. So thanks a lot for your time. I'm glad we could do this Karmasti episode, guys, which is... Jose, I'll send you the video and you can edit it to 11.
Edit it through the night. Listen, yeah. Before we go, and we've talked about so many things, but I would really want to talk about this one experience we had with Saurabh Pant. It was the afternoon. We were drinking. We both got a little naked. I'm sorry, that's a different thing. No. This was the first time I did stand up at St. Andrew's Auditorium. Was with Saurabh Pant and gang. Was this when you all were still EIC? I can't remember.
Yeah, this is EIC. This is when my their first.
This is before EIC. You branch broke out.
In Andrews,
so this first phase one is when it was EIC. Then phase two was when we had a logo with my face on it. Then phase three was without the logo.
They phased out, man.
Yeah, phased
slowly.
They were like, we don't want people to feel abandoned. It's so slow. But so first time doing stand-up and stuff, and this was St. Andrew's Auditorium, and the Aditi Mittal was there, Saurabh Pant was there, I can't recall who else, there were a bunch of other great comedians were all there, and I was standing in the wings waiting and stuff, and we had the green room. In the green room, I'm telling you, I walk in over there and I've come thinking, okay, abhi main stand-up karega and all, and I had some kind of like vague thoughts in my head, and I see Saurabh Pant going through an Excel sheet, and he's got a document, and he's got a time codes, and he knows when he's going to say what, and he's all his bullet points and everything, and he's done so much of research, and he had everything there. And I was like, oh fuck. And in that moment, I shat myself, and I was like, oh my God, I'm going to get screwed. So I asked someone for a pen and all. I got so nervous. I asked someone for a pen. I wrote everything on my hand. I wrote all the bits that I was going to do, like talking about Amitabh Bachchan shitting and weird stuff like that. Just those conversations. I wrote it all on my hand. And and then I went up, and when I performed it, I said also, hey, you know, I'm not as good as these guys. But bro, I'm telling you, if I don't know how many people here who are watching you now on your YouTube have seen Saurabh Pant live on stage.
Yeah.
But man, I was in shock, literally in shock, because I was like, what? I was just talking to Saurabh Pant off stage 2 seconds ago, and he's like, hey, yeah, man, you know, I'm going to be doing stand-up, and best of luck and everything. And this is the conversation. Show starts. Saurabh Pant is on stage. He's like,
Yeah, that's about it. That's right.
And the energy was on fire, bro. Aditi was amazing also that day, I remember. But Saurabh was on fire, and I kept thinking, fuck, how do I go on after this guy? How am I supposed to match up to this? I'm screwed. But wow, what a sight to see Saurabh Pant from the wings performing, man. Amazing. I was just standing there in the wings like that watching it. wow. Amazing. So big round of applause to Saurabh Pant, everybody.
Thank you. But I gotta
this
say
not so, scripted
so,
at all.
So we had I think we were doing a show called, was it Tuesdays with Moron? I think we'd had like 4 or 5 people doing sort of quote unquote celebrity stand-up. And Jose was the most chilled out person to do. I think Cyril and me went to his house, and Jose's like, yeah. And then he's like, this is my script. I'm like, go ahead, do it. We had somebody else who was doing a 5-minute set, who's asking us, can you write it for me? And I'm like, the point is that it's your stand-up.
But perform aapko hi karna padega.
Yeah. And we had to go for 6 different meetings with this person. I'm like, what is this?
Oh my God.
I'm like, dude, just fucking do your thing. You're a professional performer in whatever format. Hey, hi.
That was the greatest fun ever doing stand-up.
Yeah, that's real star.
Time ever. Mera bachcha. Dil ka sachcha. Dimag ka thoda kachcha.
Hi, Chloe.
But bahut achcha. Girl saying hi.
She can't hear you guys.
Okay, you one sec. Yo. Say hello, Uncle Saurabh, Cyril. That's Uncle Saurabh.
Hi, Chloe.
Haven't chatted with him much. You know Uncle
he's lost
Suresh.
His tooth, what? He's what? Lost his tooth.
Yeah, he's lost his tooth.
Yeah, that's
it. Oh, it fell off.
These kids are like those internet commenters. I've recently started getting messages saying, Jose, What happened?
Bhagwat, that's it.
Your mother's going to have a chat with you about things that you say on live streams.
Sandwich on your face.
Great thing. Yeah, sandwich on your face is the funniest thing, man.
Yeah.
Dude, there was somebody at that show, dude, the one where Jose did. Rohan Pan was at the show at Nehru Auditorium. Holy shit, dude. Fuck. That was a long time back. Nice. Dude, I remember we had hired out Nehru Auditorium back then.
Wow.
And I think the rental was about some 55,000. And we had done 4 shows there. And in the 4 shows that we did at Nehru Auditorium, we made 4,000 rupees. because we were not even selling that much tickets to get it going and all that stuff. Anyway, dude, this has been fun, guys. I know we've hit the 2-hour mark. Thanks a lot, Cyril Dabs. Thank you, Suresh Menon. Thank you, Jose. If there's anything you guys would like to plug, please go ahead. Anything that's coming up, any dates, any whatever it is, please go ahead. Yes,
I got one question, sir. Last show ka payment baki aur is show ka bhi baki hai bas utna hi
wo mera accountant hai wo bhejne wala hai uska murder ho gaya actually should abhi update mila
you can pay him like how we normally pay each other in Kaan Masti
yeah
there was special payment method
now he can't do that don't
what is the payment method
you have to watch the episodes
Jose headphones on na
Jose can have everything 1, 2, 3 Chloe wants to say something go for
yep.
it
yep
I was not
gonna
say it.
Are you sure?
Say it, Chloe.
No.
Say, come on.
Your Uncle Cyril is insane.
Yeah.
That's...
no.
That I am.
Thank you, Uncle Saurabh.
Feeling shy. Okay, chal, bag. Bag yeah.
Saurabh, thank you for having us on this.
Yeah, man. Thank you so much, yeah. Saurabh.
I mean, we really don't like each other as far as Suresh, me and Jose are concerned. This is all fake.
What?
But,
yeah.
But, yeah.
Nice, man. Good outro.
Yeah. So this is how we end all our shows, by the way. So we have an awkward moment. And that's
oh, shit. Sorry. Okay, wait. Okay, I'll just promote what's coming next and then we'll do the awkward ending. Okay, that's okay. Just to keep it good. Okay, so on Saturday, we have Cyrus Brocha and Kunal Vijaykar at 11 o'clock. Sunday
so you're
is a holiday.
Be silent.
Yeah, I'm going to be silent. I'm just going to be like, and there's some allegations that Cyrus made on his podcast about me. Fun allegations, not anything terrible.
Achha.
Everybody right now is like, fuck this guy also.
No, he's got his Brocha has got some problems. Anyway.
Yeah. So he's on Saturday, Sunday, we're taking a break. Monday is Harsha Bhogle and Anu Menon and Kumar Varun. Oh. And a bunch of people post that. Again, I have a show on Saturday, Sunday. Tickets are on saurabhpant.com. You can support the show on Instagram. Well, all this nonsense. That's bringing us to the end of this episode of Kaan Masti.
How do you end your live streams, Saurabh? The endings are always very, very awkward. It's so strange. Yeah. Hey, you want to see the funniest awkward ending is on Kaniz's last live stream, okay? She's genuinely trying to stop the stream and you can hear the mouse clicking. She's just like, bye guys, bye. This goes on for a couple of seconds. She's really doing it. It's so funny. You must watch that.
Anyway, we're done, guys. See you.
Saurabh.
He's just like, bye.
There's something I wanted to say, basically. So, I just want to say something about Jose, which I think everyone should know about. And I think it's meant to.
I knew both of them are going to do that. I mean, no, seriously. Jose is there. Seriously. I knew he was going to do that. So, bye.
Okay, bye, guys. Thanks a lot. Thank you for coming. Appreciate it.
Bye. Take care.
Love you
Thank
all.
You so
Marry
much.
Marry me. See you later.
It was great fun. We really enjoyed ourselves. Lindu Kami, unite.
Yeah.
Hey, I'll be touring my own YouTube channel also this coming week.
Yeah.
Oh, you are doing lives or what now?
No, as an artist.
You already did a live.
Stuff on my own channel.
Nice. Good
That's
plan.
A joke.
Okay, man. Ta-da.
Okay, bye. See you guys.
Bye. See you. Bye.
Bye, Saurabh. Thank you so much for having
Thanks,
us.
Guys.
Round
Thanks,
guys. Thanks
for coming. Round of applause for you guys. Yeah.
Thanks for Saurabh Pant.
Okay,
entertainer extraordinaire. Sexy person. Beautiful heart. Great human being. And entertainer of the masses. He's not yet clicked the button. Still waiting. I don't know how long I can keep this going. Please. Click the button. You are a wonderful human being. You're a great father. Your wife might say that's debatable. All round beautiful person. You're really letting me, you're just milking this Saurabh. Press the button. I beg of you. Are you in a hotel right now outside a bathroom? What are you doing?
Okay, chala, I'll end it. Bye. See ya.